let's get on with the show. Get your horns up! The Five Sound Champions are here! Get your horns up! We're going for a six-pack this year! Toss that coin up in the air! Bring them boys up to the line! Hold your horns up high because it's Bison time!
Good afternoon and welcome inside the Fargo Dome for NDSU football here on the KVLY and KFYR Bison Network. I'm Brian Shawn, he's Lee Timmerman. We'll have the call coming up for you in just a couple of moments as the Bison get set to take on Eastern Washington out of the Big Sky in what is a major contrast of styles, LT.
It certainly is. You have a team with the Bison that would love to have close to 50 rushes today. You have the Eagles that'll put the ball in the air maybe close to 50 times. So which style? Well, it depends on which defense plays the best.
And North Dakota State offensively hoping to improve on maybe some missed opportunities in their first game against Charleston Southern, and an opportunity to do it against Eastern Washington defense that gave up nearly over 500 yards against Washington State in the opener.
Yeah, the Eagles defense did give up a bunch, but I think you go back to your first part of your statement there, Brian, where Coach Kleiman said what's the number one thing he wanted to do in the opener? Play a clean game. The Bison did not come close to playing a clean game, so they'll want to get a lot of those penalties that ended some drives against Charleston Southern eliminated.
And certainly the Bison defense going to have to step up and play. We're not sure if Nick DeLuca is going to go or not, and how close to 100% he is. We'll find that out here coming up in just a couple of moments. We have the opening kickoff coming up, but first here's Beth Houle with a sideline report. Beth.
This matchup is going to be a clash of philosophies when it comes down to it. You've got Eastern Washington against North Dakota State. The Eagles, who love to pass the ball and get after it and win a game with their offense. When it comes to North Dakota State, of course, they love that run game and they like a strong defense to play in this game. Now, actually, in talking to Coach Kleiman, he says today the best defense that the Bison can have is from their offense. They need to hold on to that football. They need to keep Eastern Washington off of the field so that Cooper Kupp and his slew of wide receivers don't have a chance to make an impact in this game. Now, of course, in doing that, Coach Kleiman is expecting them to run the ball upwards of 50 times. They ran it about 44 last week, or last game. They're looking for about 50 carries this time from the Bison offense.
Beth, thank you. North Dakota State taking the field in the usual way that they do. On the tunnel, making their way out to the Gate City Bank Field turf as we get set for kickoff here in just under a minute from now.
Well, I know around these parts, Brian, we might be a little biased, but we've seen it so many times. The tunnel walk cannot, if you're not fired up for kickoff after you watch that, whether you're at home or in this building, then you're just not a football fan, because that's pretty cool.
And it is a sold-out crowd like all North Dakota State home games. I think the season sold out in about 22 minutes this year. And LT, what are you looking for early? I think that's what's always interesting, to find out which style of play is going to dictate tempo. And we're going to find out here in the first couple of series.
Well, I think whichever offense can establish what it wants to do, the one thing, too, you'll find a different twist, a much different twist to a Bison defense. Usually they're just pound, go after that quarterback, go after that quarterback. Today might be a little bit different, because when we talked to the coaches late in the week on Thursday, Coach Entz, the defensive coordinator, was saying, hey, we might go with some three down defensive linemen and get an extra D back in there right off the bat. When's the last time you've seen an NDSU defense do that? So that will be something that Eastern should not be ready for.
Eastern Washington will kick off. Bruce Anderson deep for North Dakota State. Led the country in kickoff return yardage a year ago at almost 29 yards of return. This kickoff brought to you by Peterson Pharmacy. Kick off your planning season with Peterson Pharmacy. And this one kind of a wobbler, and Lance Dunn's going to pick it up at the 8. Find some room in the inside, and a nice return out to the 28 on what looked like might be a broken return. Ends up being pretty good for the sophomore out of Waterloo.
Good kick. You don't want to Anderson, if you're Eastern, you do not want Anderson to run it. They got another good guy in Dunn to be able to take the ball, but it did disrupt the timing of the kick return.
So here we go. Easton Stick coming out 9-0 as a starter. Did not play particularly well against Charleston Southern, but not too bad either. 17-27.
Yeah, he had
two touchdowns in that game.
Career high in attempts and completions, and yes, he did not play all that well. He knows there's a lot of room for improvement.
I formation for North Dakota State. Room to the outside and good pursuit from the backside. That time by Eastern Washington's Kurt Calhoun for the takedown after just a couple of yards as King Frazier gets his first carry as we take a look at the Shield starting lineup for North Dakota State.
Colin Connor, Mineral Point, Wisconsin.
Zach Johnson, Apple Valley, Minnesota.
Tanner Volson, Belfort, North Dakota.
Jack Plankers, Leonard, North Dakota.
Landon Leckler, Beach, North Dakota.
Connor Wentz, Pinellas, Florida.
Brock Robin, Cabo.
King Frazier, Kansas City, Missouri.
RJ Arzendowski, Omaha, Nebraska.
Darius Shepard, Blue Spring, Missouri.
And Bruce Anderson rips off a big run to the outside. And the outside run, something that Tim Polasek, the offensive coordinator at North Dakota State, hoping was going to be there today, LT.
Well, Coach Polasek figured either the inside or the outside will be open. And so far, he tried the outside. Once to his offense's left, once to his offense's right, and you're up to midfield. Two real nice runs to start it for the Bison.
Good luck at your Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Shepard, the motion man there for North Dakota State. Play action. Stick fires on the run, and this one in and out of the hands of his intended target, Darius Shepard. We'll bring up second and 10.
Tell you, Shepard's made enough big plays, catches, that we're not used to him not holding on.
Here's your Shield starting lineup for that Eastern Washington defense. A couple of changes here today. Matthew Somer, third-team All-Big Sky, not playing for the second straight week, still nursing an injury, and Alex Ketchmarchik, outside linebacker, one of their leading tacklers on this team, he is out with a concussion. So Kettner Cup, that is Cooper's brother, getting his first career start today at outside linebacker. Back to the ground game. Frazier keeps his feet, gains almost five inside Eastern Washington territory to the 48.
Zach Bruce, one of the safeties, coming up to make a tackle as the Bison switched. They shift trade motion. They do a lot of that pre-snap and do an unbalanced on the right side. Look for the Bison to maybe run some things, possibly option to the weak side of this. But so far, Coach Polasek is calling plays to try to see what Eastern is going to do against the strength of its offensive line.
Three receivers out here for the Bison, two running backs on third and five. Stick to throw in the flat. And overshot his target, Anderson. Pretty good coverage on the play there anyway by Cole Karstetter, and the Bison will have to punt it away.
Well, Stick missed a couple of throws 2 weeks ago. Most of his misses were to the left. This time, he just airmails it off to the right.
And on to punt, Jackson Koontz, who did not have a great day punting against Charleston Southern, just averaged 33 yards a kick. We'll try to improve on that here today against a very explosive Eastern Washington offense. Cooper Cup back, calls for the fair catch, and makes it at the 15-yard line. And that's where the Eagles will have it to start their first drive.
Well, the Bison believe that the set of wide receivers that you're going to see today is quite possibly the best wide receiver group that NDSU may have ever played against. So we know Cooper Kupp's the All-American, but there's a lot more, especially in the receiving end, to this offense than just number 10.
And the crowd coming to their feet here as Eastern Washington offense takes the field. Nick DeLuca is out there as North Dakota State goes four down, three linebackers, just a base defense here to start things off on first down. This pass by Gubrud, that's Gage Gubrud, is incomplete, looking for Kendrick Bourne, and that was to the far side of Bourne, and we'll bring up second and 10. Starting lineup for the North Dakota State defense, brought to you by Shields.
Nate Tangley, Iguanago, Wisconsin.
Aaron Settle, Carlos, Minnesota.
Greg Menard, Lakeland, Minnesota.
MJ Stump, Harvey, North Dakota.
Nick DeLuca, Omaha, Nebraska.
Pierre G. Tucker, Belleville, Illinois.
Jalen Winbush, St. Petersburg, Florida.
Robbie Grimsley, Hutchinson, Minnesota.
Trey Dempsey, Lakeland, Florida.
Dylan Allison, Papillion, Nebraska.
Inside run did not work for Eastern Washington, and they are backed up now to third and 10.
DeLuca again getting that start. He's got his left shoulder issue, but man, he was in the backfield in a hurry on that last defensive play.
Just three down linemen here for Gubru, who's going to try to run. Then he throws to Bourne, and incomplete. Would have been enough for a first down, was a little bit behind him, and a three and out for Eastern Washington.
That will be huge if NDSU with three down linemen can get pressure on the quarterback today. That will be big.
Here's a look at the Eastern Washington offense that is leaving the field. We'll take a look at them when they come back on. Jordan Descalo, a transfer from Washington State, a pretty good punter and also a pretty good field goal kicker. He's 4 of 5 from his career in field goals and averaging 42 yards a punt in his career as well. A nice, high, deep punt. Perkins has to retreat all the way to his own 30, eludes a man, but can't get away from the second man, still able to do what he can to get some yardage back up to the 35-yard line. Simba Webster comes in to make the tackle. Simba and Zuzi, you will see both of those guys today, one on the offensive side of the ball, one on the defensive side of the ball, and yes, they are brothers.
Well, and you mentioned the Cups, and brothers on each side of the ball as well.
So the Bison offense will start on their own 35.
First down was an issue against Charleston Southern. There was no doubt about it. First down percentage, first down efficiency, I guess, is the way the coaches call it. That was not well done by NDSU 2 weeks ago.
Stick in the flat to a wide open Chase Morlock. And the senior out of Moorhead, Minnesota, has a first down all the way up to the 48.
I love it when you ask any coach about Chase Morlock, and the one thing they first thing they say, he's a football player. And when coaches, meaning he does everything, he's willing to do everything, he shuts up, he does his job, he's strong, he'll block, he'll catch.
Three backs in the backfield with Easton Stick here out of the shotgun here on first down. Bruce Anderson getting strung out, and a nice job defensively by the young corner, Josh Lewis, coming up to make the tackle for a loss of 5 all the way back to the 43.
Nunak Mutual Insurance replay. I do like this Delta formation in that you get so many playmakers an opportunity, to do some things. But Anderson did nothing but run sideways. Well played by the Eagles, unable to turn it up.
There is a look at Kettner Cup. Played as a true freshman last year, mainly on special teams. Stick will go to the air, drops it off to his tight end. Excuse me, that might be a Dallas Freeman. Or is there Eric Perkins?
No, Perkins.
It is Perkins that makes the catch all the way inside Eastern Washington territory to the 48. We'll bring up 3rd and 6.
Out of the slot, just a little stick route there. Perkins just finds a little hole between the outside linebacker and the farthest corner. Sets up shop, hopes to break a tackle. He did break one, but still it's 3rd and long for NDSU. Something, again, that kind of got the Bison in week one. They're hoping to avoid these situations. They've been in them. This is the second time already.
Morlock will motion back to the backfield. Stick has time. Looking. Now taking off with it and fires. And pretty good coverage on the play there by Zuzi Webster on the intended target, Dimitri Williams.
I think Cole Karstetler is going to be called for. He knocked Ilias all the way to the ground at about the 40-yard line.
Now, there was a flag that came up pretty early, it looked like, LT.
I think it's on Karstetter. We'll see. Holding. Yep.
And that will keep the chains moving here for North Dakota State on third down. Here's a look at it in the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Yeah.
Holding, tackling. If you were on a wrestling mat, you'd get 2 points for that, but we're not on a wrestling mat. That's a first down.
Karstetter, a sophomore from Spokane, and really a lot of these guys, LT, for Eastern Washington, still pretty young, especially in the back seven.
And you will see a ton of players from the state of Washington on Eastern's roster. I heard the athletic director say about 70%.
And it looked like somebody moved early there for North Dakota State, and that will cost the Bison 5.
I mean, any football game is that way, what a difference penalties can make. But, I mean, third down, you know, from Eastern's perspective, they had the Bison third and long. It was an incomplete pass. You get a holding call. You give them a first down. Now the Bison think, hey, let's take advantage of the break that we just got. You move early, and now you're at first and long.
Brock Robbins, the freshman fullback from Cavalier, called for the false start. Dallas Freeman, the motion man. Back to the ground, and no gain on the play. Again, nice job by Eastern Washington getting in the backfield. Dylan Ledbetter.
Well, there's different ways to attack power. That was a power play come right up the middle, one of those NDSU bread and butter plays, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Well, if you can get around the edge and get in deep into the backfield, which is exactly what Ledbetter did there. He's that freshman. Did you say freshman? Yeah, freshman player. So one of those young guys getting in there defensively. Well, first and long is bad. What's worse, than first and long? Long. How about second and long?
Bison going with five wide here on second and 15. And Stick will throw. Hangs on to it. Now he's going to take off with it. Gets up to the 40. Gain of about three. We'll set up third and 12.
Well, if there's a defense who's used to playing against four and five wides, I would think the Eagles would be real used to it if you come and spread out on them, because that's what they face in practice every day.
See what Tim Polasek, offensive coordinator for the Bison, dials up here. Fly sweep outside to Darius Shepherd. He's got a lane. Shepherd inside the 30 and leapfrogs all the way to the 20-yard line. Good enough for an NDSU first down.
Two things on that play. Eastern gambled up the middle, so NDSU had the right play called, and the other one was the downfield block of Ilias. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Will we catch number 86? Well, you're just seeing somebody get up off the turf. We missed the block itself. We had a beautiful block about 10 yards down. There it is on the left side. Another good push from Erzendowski, who has become a very good blocker, by the way. And the Bison continue the drive.
Big conversion there for North Dakota State. 20 yards on the game. Eastern Washington all over that read option play. A loss of one as King Frazier is dropped in the backfield. And Kirk Calhoun once again making a stop. He's been active early.
You know, I know we're a yard, Brian, away from the technical red zone, but this is the position on the field. Whichever defense plays inside the 20 the best today probably wins.
Stick rolling, inside screen, Lance Dunn, caught from behind by one of the Eastern Washington defensive linemen. Nice job by JT Tiulu coming back to make the stop.
He's a big kid too, 315. Making the read. It's like, oh, here's the screen. I need to get back as fast as I can. And he does do that, because I thought that play looked bigger than 4 yards when it was starting to develop.
So third and six coming up.
And Eastern could put some beef right in the middle, too. There's a couple of 300-pounders on the roster that do play in that rotation to plug up the middle.
Stick will throw across the middle. Throws and fires complete. Jeff Ilias has the catch inside the 10. Good enough for a Bison first down.
At first glance, Brian, I thought Stick might have pulled the trigger just a hair late on that crossing route there from Ilias. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Looking right. There he spots him. Has to get it just past the umpire and squeeze it in between those two Eagle defenders.
And this has been a long drive for North Dakota State. Frazier tiptoeing through the hole, now bouncing outside. Still on his feet, King Frazier! Touchdown, North Dakota State!
The carry was not as far, but the run itself was somewhat reminiscent of the game-winning touchdown in overtime against Charleston Southern. That play's designed. You saw Frazier look a couple of ways to try to get something up the gut. It wasn't there. He bounced it, saw the cone, and then got his body into the end zone.
So King Frazier, his second touchdown of the season. And North Dakota State grabs an early 6-0 lead, extra point pending.
Because of some big third down conversions on that drive. That was the key.
Peterson, Cam Peterson adds on the extra point, and North Dakota State takes a 7-0 lead with 6:19 to go in the first quarter. We'll be back with more first quarter action from the Fargo Dome. You're watching KVLY, KFYR, Bison Network. Back at the Fargo Dome, today's Bison football game is brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs.
Well, it's always a tough job to get the football into the end zone, and that's what NDSU did first here today.
Cam Peterson on for the kickoff. And this one returned out to about the 18-yard line by Nick Splendorio. As we take a look at today's quarterback comparison. Brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission.
What a debut for that guy, huh?
Yeah, Gage Gubrud comes out, really wins the job out of nowhere, and then goes for a school record in total terms of total yardage, completing 34 passes for 5 touchdowns and 474 yards.
You know you had a special day when you take a guy by the name of Vernon Adams and wipe him off the record book at Eastern Washington. 551 total yards in the win over Washington State last week.
Again, Gubrud, a sophomore, is a former walk-on, and he beat an incoming senior for the job. Handoff outside goes to Jabari Wilson, and he's close to a first down all the way up to the 29-yard line.
Boy, tremendous block on the edge as Menard was pinned in there. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. And then Stump couldn't get there to cut the corner off. 9-yard gain on first down.
Wilson again will carry, and he has a first down across the 30 to the 33. A flag comes in late.
I think Eastern on a holding call here is going to wipe out a first down. But I know it's early in this game, Brian, but this to me could be a big series for Bo and his team, just because you have to find a way to answer. In center.
That's Jared Jones, the lone senior. We haven't talked about it yet, but 5 brand new offensive linemen starting here today. They lost their top 7 offensive lineman from last year to graduation.
That's almost, I mean, that's just about unheard of. And then to come out and give Gubrud the time that he needed. I know that they run a bunch of short passes and all that, but to get him the time to have the record against Washington State, that was huge. So that was certainly a question mark coming in. And they're a little worried about the depth, too, on that offensive line. There's not a lot of guys behind him with this quick tempo offense. So those O-linemen better be in shape.
Second down and long. Inside screen to Bourne, stutter steps his way and then taken down, and he is very close to a first down, maybe a half yard short.
Going to be right about where they were before that last penalty. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Great job. You get what, 3 guys on 3 out front, 3 white jerseys all on the Bison blocking in front of that little slip screen bubble, some people call it, style. Third and short.
Third down and less than a yard for Eastern Washington. Gubrud's going to keep it, and he is close. And oh boy, that's going to come down to the spot. I think he's got enough to the 29.
I think the line judge on the high side has him in first down territory. You know, Gubrud had that real nice run too last week. Was that a 30-some yard touchdown? And here's the pace of play that the Eagles like. They're looking for that play to come in quick. Even though a couple of runs have been effective, Brian, we know this is a passing team. I don't know if the Eagles are a team that's really dedicated to running the ball. They want the ball in the air.
Little end around, and this goes to Kupp. Kupp is looking to throw it, and he's going to be taken down by Pierre G. Tucker for a loss of five.
I'm not sure who Kupp was trying to look for. I think he started to peek over his shoulder to look for a deep route, and the tight end, Zach Wimberly, got caught up on a drag. You saw him kind of look, and then he just has to get what he can, and that's not much. Now, Kupp, he played quarterback for a play, threw a pass, almost was a touchdown last week. He can and will do a little bit of everything.
Second and 15, Gubrud back across the middle, and this one is complete. First catch of the day for Shaq Hill, the senior that missed all of last year after injuring a knee against Oregon in the season opener. Came back last week at a seven catches for 119 yards against Washington State in a victory.
Yeah, he was a starter in 14 and really kind of making this wide receiver group unique. His ability to become that threat that he was a couple of years ago. It's tough to guard all these guys. Three down linemen for the Bison, two linebackers.
Gubrud back, fires in the flat, and this one is incomplete. Robbie Grimsley on the coverage. The intended target there was Stu Stiles, and that will bring up fourth down for Eastern Washington.
Well, that's where Grimsley's going to play when you're in a true nickel situation. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You see him there in that shallow flat. He's trying to make a read. He's playing a zone. Do I need to go to the outside or worry about the guy cutting across my face? Pass came across his face, and he was in a real good position.
So the Bison able to get off the field on third down, which is not easy to do against Eastern Washington.
And keep in mind, the Bison are doing things today defensively. You just saw it on that last play that they have not done. So this week was a real big learning week.
Perkins calls for the fair catch at the 26-yard line. And that's where the Bison will have it when we come back.
Media timeout.
Leading 7-0 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Back at the Fargo Dome, North Dakota State getting set for their second offensive possession. As we take a look at the quarterback comparison brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission for Easton Stick. And Stick in his first game as really the full-time starter of this offense. Not too bad. Chase Morlock still on his feet, but he lost his helmet, so the play is whistled dead. Or Chase might still be running for a while. So he's whistled down after a gain of four instead of, who knows.
By rule, once the ball carrier's helmet comes off, the play is dead. It will be second down at the spot where the helmet came off. I think the number 25 must leave the field for one play.
You know, fans are booing that situation, but hey, the rule's the rule, and it's done for safety. And, you know, you're right, Brian, that one might have popped, but instead you get a four-yard gain.
Stick will bring the offense back. Outside run. Frazier able to turn the corner. Lance Dunn turning the corner to the 34. About 3 yards short of a first down. We'll bring up third and three.
I thought Tiuli had very good pressure up the middle again. He was able to get deep enough in the backfield that NDSU had to belly that one out a little farther than he wanted to.
Here is a look at Easton Stick for your quarterback comparison brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission. 21 completions, 228 yards, and averaging almost 4 yards a carry in the opener as well.
Yeah, that's added up. He had 194 yards passing, so they're adding as we go.
Back to the ground game. Frazier did not get a first down. Taken down at the 36. Looked like he had a big hole and he was going to bust it for a big one, and he comes up short.
Well, I think Frazier's going to want this back. To me, you put the shoulder down and get the first down. He bounced, I think, to try to see if he could pop it. Well, he switched the ball to the right hand and then kind of lost momentum. Real nice job by Fettig to come up and make that tackle and make it fourth down.
So the Bison will have to punt. And Jackson Koontz back on the field.
I think the Bison coaches will go, it's a little too soft at the point of contact on that run.
And Koontz Nice high, deep punt. Coop calling for the fair catch back at the 16. And that's where Eastern Washington will start their next possession with 1:45 to go here in the first quarter.
Media timeout.
We'll be back with more from the Fargo Dome. 7-0 North Dakota State. Back at the Fargo Dome, this game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs.
Bison defense, Brian, so far mixing it up pretty good for Downman Light right now, but you have to find a way to get your All-American the ball.
Gubru
like that.
Completes it to Cup, who breaks a tackle and has a first down to the 29-yard line. And that's the first catch of the day for Cooper Cup, who had over 200 yards receiving last week at Washington State, and he is closing in on the 5,000-yard reception mark in his career.
You're talking about a guy who almost, I don't know how close he was, but he's certainly thinking about giving up this year of college football to enter the NFL draft. That's how good Cooper Kupp is.
Custer, Antoine Custer, the true freshman, taken down. Nice job by Robbie Grimsley coming up in run pursuit for no gain.
I think Grimsley was trying so hard to try to make sure he could get to the outside and cut this off, and he dove and actually got the tackle. So he's just trying to make sure that this doesn't bounce, continue to go outside, and he's able to get an arm in there.
Custer, one of only two true freshmen that are playing out of De La Salle High School in Berkeley, California. Gubrud will throw, has an open receiver, and it is tipped away. Nice job defensively by Trey Dempsey coming over to pursuit. And Shaq Hill, the intended target there for Eastern Washington.
Hill is trying to find the soft spot in that zone. And the ball almost got there. The window closed a little bit too much as the safety was able to get over and knock that away. But the Bison elected to go zone and try to stay over the top. And they got it done.
Another third down here for Gubrud. It goes across the middle to Cup, and I think he's got enough. Depends where the official marks it.
Well,
it's close. Maybe the nose of the football.
High side guy had him short. Linesman down to the near side is going to. He's going to be on it. I think he made it. We're going to have to measure.
It's going to be very close. Take a look at the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Cup. Finding, settling down. He did come back for the ball. It's just a matter of where he caught it.
Boy, according to that, that was short. That was a good yard short, wasn't it?
Again, he came back for the ball.
Yeah. Where do you gain possession of the football? There's no doubt he ran enough to where the first down marker was, but did he catch it at that mark?
You see the elusiveness, too, of Gubrud on that play. I think he has it.
I think he's got it, too.
Yeah, it's pretty close, but. Ooh, he's short. Just barely, by just a few inches. So what does Eastern do here in their own territory? Something tells me Bo Baldwin, the head coach, ninth year, might think about going for it here.
Why not? You can't get 2 inches.
And that's pretty much all it is, too. I mean, we're talking the nose of the ball.
It's always funny, as we're this close, we know it's 2 inches. The center's going to get over the ball, move it around a little bit, and if they marked it again, you know, without the snap.
Fourth and short for the Eagles, Bison fans.
Chris Kleiman wanting them to get the play clock started. They've let things go, and the play clock still isn't moving. Now I think we're in a timeout.
That is the end of the first quarter.
And that will do it for the first quarter. And when we come back, we assume we're going to have the offense on the field for fourth and just a few inches here for Eastern Washington. Stay with us. We'll have more from the Bison and the Eagles coming up from the Fargo Dome after this. Welcome back to the Fargo Dome. Let's take a look at the new seed fan cam as Eastern Washington gets set for fourth in just a couple of inches. Oh, I don't think he got there.
It's going to be very close. They put Cup in the shotgun, ran to his right, and he tried to stretch it out. And they only needed a couple of inches, and they'll need the chains again.
Needs the ball to break across the 29-yard line, and it is going to be right at that point. Cooper Cup hoping their senior All-American could get them a couple of inches, and if he did, he just got enough.
When you don't put your quarterback under center, your defensive tackles in this case.
I think he's short. Oh, he got it.
Close. Yep.
Just barely.
But like Steidel and Tangway in that particular instance don't have to worry about the squeezing the A-gaps so hard that they can go and rush at a little bit different angle, and it almost cost the Eagles on that possession.
So Eastern Washington able to convert and keep the drive alive, trailing 7-0. So Gubrud back to work here for the Eagles. Cup on the end around, breaks a couple of tackles, and then Nick DeLuca slams into the turf after a gain of 5.
When Cup went in motion, Grimsley went with him, so he was spying him on that play. His safety counterpart moved him inside. Gain of about 5.
Let's take a look at our Bobcat game recap. North Dakota State scoring drive, 10 plays, 65 yards, almost 6 minutes off the clock, and ended with a King Frazier touchdown run. Gubrud back to work, holds on to it, can't find anybody. Now to the other side of the field, an airmail to wide open receiver. Shaq Hill was all by himself at the 40, and now a flag is out at the 48.
I didn't see what the flag was, but I'll tell you, the defensive backs on the near side were picture perfect on that particular instance. Gubrud, option 1, not there. Option 2, not there.
A legal man downfield here for Eastern Washington. So does Chris Kleiman accept the penalty and move Eastern back, or does he take the incompletion and bring up third down?
Ineligible receiver downfield, offense number 64. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Coach Kleiman elects to back them up. Penalty call there on Chris Schlichting. One of two freshmen that are starting here for Eastern Washington today on the offensive line.
Starting side by side, too. How unusual is that? No senior or upperclassman to help bail you out. Two rookies on that left side.
Bison three down linemen. Nick DeLuca showing pressure. Here come the Bison. Gubrud is hit and still completes the pass, gets it off and delivers it on the back shoulder. Another first catch of the day for Stu Stiles, and that's a first down to the 38.
Stiles ends up having a linebacker on him. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. It's Stump trying to catch up. He got turned around a little bit. MJ did. Beats Bachmeyer to safety to the spot. Real nice pitch and catch.
Custer takes on Jalen Allison and plows his way ahead for about 7 to the 31. Excuse me, that was Pierce, the other freshman that got the carry, not Custer. Tamarik Pierce, the other freshman, true freshman out of Oakland, California.
That's just a great job when you can get that many yards on first down.
Gubrud is going to keep it. Gubrud is elusive, and he has a first down inside the 25 to the 22. Eventually taken down there as Jalen Allison and Nick DeLuca come in to make the stop.
Well, I thought for a moment there, Brian, that one had enough to get all the way to the end zone. Perfect call. You see Stanley Jones gets caught inside. You get a real nice block on the corner as well. The Bison certainly took the bait on the fake handoff. And the flag is out in front of Eastern's bench and way on the high side.
Illegal formation. 5-man in the backfield. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
So that wipes out the run on the illegal formation. And so far, penalties have really hurt Eastern Washington here in the first half. It's already the fourth penalty accepted by North Dakota State against the Eagles.
And when you're taking first downs away from yourself, if you watched the Georgia Southern game, you know how disruptive that can be to an offensive flow. It happened to NDSU 2 weeks ago. Now the Eagles have done it a couple of times here in the first half to themselves.
Gubrud's going to keep it again, trying to follow his running back up the middle, gains a couple, and then a flag comes in late.
You know what, might get a little extra on the end of this tackle. It was DeLuca on the tackle. He might have twisted a little bit too much on the end.
And do we have a female official here today on the crew? We did want to point that out today.
Saw when she came in, saw when the crew came in. But whenever you have a chance as a defender to get a little, to get some body on a quarterback, you do it. I'm guessing this twist right there, smacking him down a little bit too much, and then.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense number 29. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, he called Bachmeyer's number, but he meant 49.
Yeah, that's still, that 29, goes on to Luca.
29 was nowhere near the play. Because Eric's playing, is pairing deep middle safety. Now that was on DeLuke, it was on the tackle.
So that moves the ball now inside the 20-yard line, or right to the 20-yard line. Eastern Washington looking to tie this thing up. Gubrud to throw, facing pressure across the middle, complete! Touchdown, Eagles! Cooper Kupp has another one.
Well, that's a new FCS record, too, because every time he does that, he'll break his own record. He had the three last week to become the all-time FCS touchdown reception leader, and what a really nice move. He gave a little hip to the outside, busted it back in, stayed true to the seam, perfect strike. A strike, rather, from the quarterback.
So Eastern Washington almost didn't even have this drive going. They convert a fourth and 2 inches by maybe an inch. And they're able to go down and take advantage and score.
In the big picture of this game, very important drive right there from Eastern Washington.
Roldan Alcobendas adds the extra point for Eastern Washington, and we're tied at 7 with 12:54 to go here in the second quarter. Seven's your score on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. Back to the Fargo Dome in just a moment. Today's Bison football game on the KVOY and KFYR Bison Network in high definition. Glad you could be with us. Brian, Sean, Lee Timmerman with you as we are tied at 7 from here at the Fargo Dome as we take a look at the Bobcat game recap and that scoring drive for Eastern Washington. Pretty impressive. Ends with a 20-yard touchdown reception. Cooper Kupp from Gage Gubrud.
Yeah, 5 first downs on that drive, and then Kupp, the move he put on Grimsley, he took his 2 feet and just kind of planted him to the turf. So Cooper Kupp showing why he is NFL worthy.
10-play drive for Eastern. Again, doing most of the damage through the air as we take a look at another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. And
onside.
Onside kick. And it's still loose, and I think Eastern got it. They did. What a move by the Eagles. And coming up with it, Simba Webster, one of the backup wide receivers.
I think Trey Fort had it in his hands for a little bit.
Really,
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
By the receiving team.
37, I think, is Most Fort.
And recovered by the kicking team. First down, Eastern Washington.
Yep, first touch by the Bison. Up on the shoulder. Shaq helps strip it out of there. And absolutely, it is Eagles ball.
So Bo Baldwin, a bold move here at the Faro Dome. And just like that, his offense is back on the field. Trailing, or not trailing, now tied.
The Bison defense thinking, hey, we're going to get a little bit of a rest, recoup after the touchdown. Nope.
Gubrud taken down by Pierre G. Tucker after a short gain at midfield.
That's one of the advantages the Bison have with Tucker's athletic ability, in that they can play Tucker as kind of the nickel back. Put him in space and use his agility to do things just like this. He's listed as a linebacker, comes in, beats the man to the spot who's trying to block him, so no block, no body on Tucker, and is able to get the quarterback.
Bison going with three down linemen again. Splendorio in motion. Gubrud going deep. He has an open receiver, and it is intercepted. Taken away by Robbie Grimsley. And Grimsley still on his feet. Got some blocks downfield, and Grimsley across midfield with a 45. Wow. What a turn of events.
For a moment there, I thought Bachmeier was maybe going to get beat deep on his deep responsibility, and Bachmeier was able to get there. 29, who as I'm talking about, he doesn't hit the receiver. He turns at the last moment, ball pops free, and then Grimsley has a nice return.
And Cup still had his hands on it. Thought he could still possibly make the catch, but Grimsley there to make the interception. Big play in the game.
I mean, that thing looked like it was going to be pass interference on Bachmeier, and then he was able to keep his hands down and turn his head at the last moment and able to avoid that, but also create just enough contact to separate the ball. That's about where the Bison would have had it if they would have gotten
the onside
NDSU
kick.
Would have got the onside kick.
So Easton Stick gets the offense back on the field. Stick play action. He's going to take a shot deep. One-on-one coverage.
Intercepted.
And I think it was picked off. Oh, wait a minute. The Bison got it.
Oh, wow.
Erzendowski was their intended target.
This could be one of those dual possession things.
Oh, boy.
Is that Karstetter who was back there? And I thought he had inside position the whole way. It did not look like Stick was able to get the ball up over the top. And then they just battled for it.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Let's take a look. Oh, boy.
Dual That's, possession.
Yeah, it is dual possession. That was a good play by both guys on the football.
That's Tucker, I think, back there defensively. He had the best position the whole way. Erzendowski just starts ripping at it as soon as he can, and they both come to the turf with the ball.
The ruling on the field is a catch by the offense. That play is under further review.
Delando Tucker was the defensive back playing back there, a junior from Federal Way, Washington. And I don't know how they overturned this.
I don't think you can. It'd be a very difficult call for anyone in the booth to overturn this, no matter what was called on the field.
And Bo Baldwin wondering how his team did not get possession back after Stick took a shot deep.
Now, Erzendowski was just unable to ever get downfield and create some separation. I mean, that was played very, very well defensively, position-wise, and then on the back end of it, you have a number 16 and a number 18 just grinding over the ball, and they both can lay claim to it, and the Bison get the call.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything there you can possibly overturn.
I
think we got
that.
First and goal at the one here for NDSU. It did look like Erzendowski even had a chance to make that catch.
It looked interception to me the whole way. And that right up until it wasn't.
Chris Kleiman in his third year as head coach.
So the way the process works is right now, our truck is feeding the booth the different angles and the different things that the replay officials want to look at.
Boy, we've had a little bit of everything in this first half, LT. My goodness, in the last 5 minutes alone.
it's been crazy. Onside kicks that work. Interceptions that tip off, that hit off your best receiver. And now this thing, to me, that looked like a sure interception, Erzendowski takes it right back. It's going to be first and goal, isn't it?
I think so.
After review, the ruling on the field will stand. First down at the 1 yard line.
Impossible to overturn that. Again, no matter what's called on the field, if the official comes down and says interception, you would say you can't overturn that.
Definitely goes NDSU's way, and they're set up first and goal at the one. Morlock is the single setback here as the Bison going to try to cash in, and now the official coming over.
They were going to talk to the official in the replay booth, I believe. And it's probably about the spot. Because the ball's about on what? A foot yard? It could be the 1 yard.
We have a correction on the spot. The ball replaced at the 2 yard line. Okay. First down, North Dakota State.
Yeah.
Okay, so move the ball back about a yard and a half.
Yeah. And it changes your play call because I think Stick was going for a quarterback sneak on that particular instance. So now you bring a different personnel group in. Robbins is in, you have Freeman in, some guys who, some extra blocking. And what, Morlock's going to stay in the eye but have some blocking help.
Yep. Brock Robbins in front of Morlock in the eye formation. And Morlock reaches across, no signal from the official. Now they're saying
that could have been
Washington
taken away
has the
from
ball.
Him. Now where did this play get blown dead? Because Morlock's trying to reach it to the goal line. And one of the Eagles rolled up on it. Was it whistled dead? Another crazy play. Two in a row.
Boy, now this depends on if the play was whistled dead because forward progress was stopped,
stop,
then it doesn't matter.
And or knee down. Okay. Morlock trying to stretch it out across the defender.
Ooh. Ooh.
That could be a fumble.
It depends.
Abukum is, I think, the guy who came in to grab it out because Morlock can only had one arm to try to reach it across.
Well, both NDSU offense, Eastern Washington defense, still out there for now.
Ruling on the field is the runner is down at the 1 yard line before the ball came out. Second down.
Now, is that reviewable?
I don't think so. I'm not going to pretend I know every play in the book that's reviewable or not reviewable, but I do not believe that's one.
Well, that's a break for NDSU, I think. And now Ball Baldwin is out on the field, and he wants them to look at it.
Officials
ruling on the field is under further review. Yeah.
Each coach gets the opportunity to review a play. I don't know if Bo makes this one as his official review, but he certainly is requesting another look at it. Back-to-back crazy
plays. This has been
plays.
A weird 5 minutes in the second quarter.
You know, we figured today would be a long game.
Anyway.
Just because of the number of passes that we were going to see, but not because we spent the last 20 minutes reviewing plays.
Well, and the other part of that, too, LT, is if Morlock reached across, did he get a touchdown out of that
did
before
he get
the ball
across?
Was loose? Yeah, because if he gets across and then the ball is loose, it doesn't matter. It would be a touchdown. If not, Eastern Washington might have the ball at the one.
But, you know, I think you go back to a similar situation as the long pass. Is there enough to overturn it clearly in the booth?
We're
I don't
find
think
out.
So.
After further review, The ruling on the field that the runner is down before the ball came loose is confirmed. Second down.
So North Dakota State keeps the football. And Bo Baldwin still doesn't think so.
Which is kind of ironic in a goal line situation when you go back to the last time these guys played, what happened on a goal line situation in 2010 with Jetson.
Oh, let's not bring up those wounds. Stick is going to keep it, and Stick.
I thought he got in.
And there was, they're saying touchdown. North Dakota State, Easton Stick.
North Dakota State.
Well, back-to-back unusual plays goes NDSU's way right before Stick is able to get the quarterback sneak in for the go-ahead score.
No dang neutral insurance replay. Let's take a look at it. Stick working off his block. Brock Robbins helping him a little bit.
Bolson did not get much of a push from his center position, which is why he went off to the left.
The ruling on the field of a touchdown is under further review.
Okay. Well,
why wouldn't it be?
Because, hey, every touchdown, every scoring play is reviewed. And so this is not probably either side looking at it. This is probably the guys upstairs saying, we want to confirm this. Every scoring play is confirmed and looked at.
What a second quarter.
I know.
We've seen everything here.
Well, just the last three plays.
Yeah.
We could have ordered a pizza and it would have gotten here.
Probably.
By the between the time that Erzendowski made the catch and by the time we get to the kickoff.
Well, Eastern Washington missing the playoffs.
After review, the ruling on the field will stand. Touchdown.
All right, so touchdown, North Dakota State. We know that. Eastern Washington missing the playoffs last year for the first time since 2011. And defensively really got into tough shape in November. They played Portland State, Northern Arizona, Montana defensively, gave up 68% on third down in the month of November. Ended up losing three straight, going 6-5, and that was the end of that. Peterson adds the extra point, and North Dakota State
media
back
timeout.
On top, 14-7 with 11 minutes to go here on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard.
Get your horns out.
Back at the Fargo Dome, this game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs.
Tough, like instant replay official jobs, like that?
14-7 your score. Peterson on for the Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. It's taken at the 5. And this is Simba Webster, who's got a lot of speed. Flag comes in. And Webster able to keep his feet and finally runs out of bounds at the 43. But again, we'll see what the flag is back at the 25.
Right in that area where Webster broke it outside and had some freedom outside, there was a cluster of players, both in green and gold and in white, and that's where the flag came.
Holding. Receiving team number 19. 10-yard penalty. First down.
That goes on Josh Lewis, who is one of the defensive backs for Eastern Washington. And that'll back up Eastern after having really good field position. Let's take another look at it on the NoDuck Mutual Insurance replay.
I didn't see the hold. He was the far, as you looked at that, the furthest guy to the left in that cluster.
Cam Peterson doing enough to at least force him out of bounds there, the kicker. Really saw the speed, though, of Simba Webster.
You know, that goes in the books as a 10-yard penalty, but really it's what, about a 30-yard penalty.
So Gage Gubrud on the offense back out there for Eastern Washington, trailing once again.
Bison back to the 3-down lineman.
And Gubrud's going to keep it, and he is taken down for a loss. Brad Ambrosius got in there.
Well, generally, the quarterback's trying to read that defensive end. What's the end doing? If he's continuing to come at me, I'm going to give it. Ambrosius played it neutral enough where Gubru didn't know what to do. He kept it. Ambrosius is right there for the loss.
So second and 13 now coming up for Eastern Washington. And the Dome crowd coming to life. Gubrud will drop it off, pass complete to Jabari Wilson, and he has some of that yardage back. Comes up with about 7 yards, will bring up third and seven.
Hold, Brian, there's a hold.
Oh, there
the
is a holding back. Flag, did not see that.
Yeah, it's going to come back. Bison mixing it up. First down was a three-down lineman where Ambrosius made the play. Next down, this one where the flag was, four-down lineman. So NDSU doing a good job with its defensive personnel mixing things up.
Holding offense number 65. Half the distance to the goal line. Replay second down.
That is already the sixth penalty here in the first half on Eastern Washington. Yeah, Greg Menard taken down.
But you did see Menard grab a little jersey. There was a little jersey in the beginning of that. And when Menard started to turn the corner, the big man just kind of bear hugged him and took him to the ground. Back to a three down lineman. This will be a max coverage situation.
Second and long. The give to the outside, and the Bison swallow up Jabari Wilson as he's able to get some yardage back to the nine. Will bring up third and 15.
Wilson, the senior running back, the most experienced of the running back, and O'Brien has talked about the two freshmen that have played a little bit here already. But so far, this deep in their own territory does not seem like the Eagles on either first or second down, Brian, really wanting to expose themselves much through the air.
Five wide here on third and long. Gubrud is going to take off with it. Gubrud gets to the 20-yard line, and then he is taken down by a host of Bison, including Nick DeLuca, will be short of a first down.
Well, that's going to be open. You're going to get that. And the reason for that, when you rush three, you have two guys to move the defensive tackle. Once he moves, it's a third down and long situation. Your linebackers are on very deep drops. Everything's covered past the first down yardage marker. Gubrud makes the decision to run it, but he's pretty sure when he runs, he's not going to pick up that first down.
So a three and out for Eastern Washington. And Dascalo back on to punt it away. This one not as good, kind of a wobbler. Bounces out of bounds right around the 38-39 yard line. And that's where the Bison will have it. So stick in the offense, coming back out here for North Dakota State, leading 14-7 with 8:40 to go here in the second quarter. Back at the Fargo Dome, Gate City Bank Field, North Dakota State leading Eastern Washington 14-7. First play of North Dakota State's drive at the 39. Stick, play action. Rolling, firing on the run, and he short hops his intended target on the play. Darius Shepherd will bring up second and 10.
Say, Brian and everyone, we have a very special thank you just to share with everybody today. Jim Sandy recently retired after 48 years with KFYR-TV and our statewide sports network. Jim produced high school tournaments for decades along with Bison football and pretty much anything sports related. Now, you may not have seen him, but you've watched his work for a long, long time. The producer, the behind-the-scenes heartbeat of a sports telecast. Just a big thank you to Jim for his leadership, his vision, and his passion. Thanks, Jim.
Outside run, and Morlock leaves his feet. Gains about 6 yards up to the 45. Will bring up third and four.
Trying to channel his inner Bonnet, which congratulations to him, by the way, Andrew.
Yeah.
For making the practice squad.
He and C.J. Smith, both practice squad.
And by the way, as long as we're talking about that team, Carson Wentz in his first NFL start. And rumor has it that the Wentzes are by a computer somewhere watching along. Your Bison have the lead, guys, right now.
Go to the run game. Oh, it opens up for
Dunn.
Lance Dunn scoots through the hole. Picks up a first down to the 36. Little tiptoe in the hole, and then boom, he hits the Jets, and there he goes.
A gorgeous hesitation, but then check his pad level, though. So he's shoulders dip down. He gets going immediately again. Beats the safety for about another, 8 or 9 yards? Lance Dunn earning some reps.
And Dunn actually led the team in carries in the opening game of the season against Charleston Southern at 12. Dunn staying in there here on first down. Back to the ground game. Dunn across the 35 to the 34 will gain about two.
Zach Bruce, one of the safeties coming up to make the tackle.
Another former walk-on. Will he earn his stripes, now a captain.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Connor Wentz, you mentioned Carson. Connor, his cousin, trying to make a little block in there. Gained a couple.
Bruce Anderson checks in at running back here on second and seven. Shepherd on the end around, trying to bubble it out. Nice open field tackle again. Eastern Washington corners doing a nice job getting in there to make the tackles, and this time Zuzi Webster comes in to make the stop.
Yeah, Freeman is out there trying to be the person to shield or make the block on Webster, and Webster was not having anything of it. Sniffs it out. Freeman is unable to get a body on him. Pretty much no gain.
Third and seven, five receivers in the formation for the Bison. Stick with time, throws across the middle, open receiver. It is caught by Jeff Ilias, touchdown.
Huge benefit on that play, Brian, of having three wides, including Morlock, the widest one out here. You suck the defense over. They're playing man up with a safety over the top. You take away one of the safeties. So soon as Stick slams that in perfect right to Ilias, he's able to break one block. There is no other safety there because he's on the near side of the field, off to the left as you viewed that replay. Touchdown, NDSU.
33 yards on the connection. From Stick to Ilias, the former Winemere Lidgerwood Warbird comes up with a touchdown reception, and North Dakota State has extended its lead to 21-7 with 6:12 to go here in the second quarter.
The way that play was drawn up influenced what the defense had to do in order to open up the middle of the field. Well executed.
So that at least gives NDSU a little more breathing room as we take a look at the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. And nice grab by Ilias, who's really put on some weight this year as well. I mean, that's one of the struggles he had coming in here.
Everybody knew he could do that. He can run routes. He can catch passes. The biggest thing that Jeff had to do was learn how to block, and he's real. And Coach Kramer's obviously helped a lot with that. That's where that weight and muscle comes from. But yeah, he just bounced off of that easily.
Ilias up to 231 pounds, where he was playing closer to 215, 220 throughout his first couple of years in the program.
No, he's made himself an every down tight end. You know, before he made catches last year, but he was in specialty type situations when he was a second or maybe sometimes third tight end. He's an every down guy now.
And Ilias taking over the hair situation for Bonnet, who left after last year.
Jealous, aren't you?
I am, actually. Peterson boots this one through the end zone, and Eastern Washington will start at the 25. Cam Peterson, guy that was really thrown into the fire last year as a walk-on true freshman, had a great NCAA championship game, hit three field goals in that game and a 37-10 victory over Jacksonville State.
Now obviously, the last time the Eagles had the ball, they had a penalty, a holding call that kind of hurt themselves. But there was a situation where the Bison defense helped create the last touchdown. It was a short field. It was, 60, 61 yards maybe on that drive. So the Bison took it over, got into Eagles territory, and were able to try some things, open up the middle for Ilias. So the defense helped set up that score.
Gubrud, 6 of 11 for 85 yards.
Oh, almost had it.
And now 6 of 12 as Big Nate Tangway thought he was going to score his first career, Tuska. Jared Tuska was going to score his first career touchdown. The Tuska brothers from Warner, South Dakota.
He was real close to having this one stick in his hands. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You look off to the left, trying to influence the defense. Jared's like, oh my goodness, there was my touchdown.
Tuska Jr. Gubrud back to work. Standing in the pocket, can't find anybody. The pressure not there. Now Gubrud all the way back to the other side of the field as an open Kendrick Bourne inside NDSU territory to the 47-yard line. And there is a flag back at the 20.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 94. 15-yard penalty added on to the end of the play, automatic first down.
And that will go on Stanley Jones, the sophomore from Bismarck, picking up the additional 15, and now Eastern all the way down inside the 35.
That did not take long. But you can't expect your defense. I know you're going max coverage, rushing three, but you cannot expect your defense to guard everybody for what? You're close
seven,
to
eight
10
seconds?
Yeah, I'd say you're pushing 10 seconds almost.
So just like that, a couple of one big play, Eastern down the field. Hand off inside and big hit in the middle by MJ Stumpf as Antoine Custer picks up three.
That was well done by both of those kids. Stump was squared up real well, got a decent lick on him, and then there were some nice yards after contact as well by the freshman.
Gubrud throwing it up to Bourne. Nicely done and caught inside the 10. And now they're thinking, was it complete?
I thought
the official said so. Would be inside the 5, down to about the 3-yard line.
Yeah, he had it.
They're going to confer.
I thought he had it. One of the few times the Bison dialed up pressure. So when you do that, you're taking away, or you're giving the offense an opportunity to try something else. And that's man coverage on the outside. NDSU had no choice because of the pressure coming from the field side.
The receiver did not maintain control of the ball. It is incomplete.
Oh, boy.
Okay, I saw the feet down.
Now one got down for sure.
Oh, and they're still battling for it.
So incomplete, and that is not reviewable.
That was Jalen Allison, too. One-on-one.
Take a look. Bourne, foot down there. The second one is not down, and he's still kind of bobbling it a little bit. Probably a pretty good call. Third and 7 coming up. And now, or can they review this?
I think you can. I thought he kind of caught that.
The ruling on the field of an incomplete pass is, we're going to have further review.
I seem to recall, for whatever reason, that play was not reviewable in the past. I may be mistaken, but
my first reaction was that Bourne had control of the ball by the time being out of bounds was established, and then the hand fighting, which the play still continued throughout. Watching it live, I thought it was a catch.
I did too.
Another way for the coaching staffs to get kind of an extra timeout.
Have to determine if he had possession of the ball in bounds before going out of bounds. Yeah, I'm kind of with you, LT.
But I thought it was a catch.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Because college is, you know, ball in hands, 1 foot down. That's a catch. Mm-hmm. And I thought he controlled it.
Enough.
I thought so.
Undisputable visual evidence. We'll find out if that's enough for the replay official to overturn it.
Coach Baldwin, as we watch the replays and things going on here, Coach Baldwin, and Brian and I talked about this before, back in the mid-90s, he was the quarterback coach for Central Washington when the University of Mary played Central Washington in the national semifinals. He was the quarterback coach, and the quarterback on that team, John Kitna. So some pretty good success there as well, with a little bit of a North Dakota tie between Baldwin and a North Dakota-based team.
That was a really nice ball there from Gubrud. Put it right on the money to Bourne. Had a real tight window to squeeze it in.
I thought he made... Let's get the call.
The ruling on the field of an incomplete pass will stand after further review.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a tough break.
But you know what? This is going to sound repetitive because I've said it already, but if that was called a catch,
then it would still be a catch.
It would still be a catch.
So now we do have third and seven.
Instead of first and goal.
Bison bring three. Gubrud fires, completes. And that is Cooper Kupp making another catch as another late flag comes in at the 35. And Kupp has a first down to the 21, pending the flag.
Roughing
personal
again.
Foul. Roughing the passer. Number 96. Low hit to the quarterback. Half the distance to the goal line. First down.
Now Chris Kleiman doesn't like that call. As Greg Menard called for the roughing the passer, hitting below the waist.
When Kupp has done his damage today, it has been from the slot. Here it is, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Brood's going to get rid of it. Oh boy, he was there when he was throwing. That wasn't late, was it?
I think he said
just hitting
below.
Period. Okay.
So that moves the ball now inside the 10.
But if you're watching from out in Washington, you're thinking,
finally,
our team should have had the ball about here anyway.
Fade. Oh, Cooper Kupp went up and got the football. Touchdown.
He also created some space. When the ball was in the air, Kupp was able to get a hand on the defender, create some space for himself, and haul it in.
It looked like Jalen Allison had it played perfectly.
Watch the ISO on this. I thought Kupp is able to do the veteran move. There's the space, a little bit of push, an easy touchdown. And the Eagles are on the board. Veteran move.
Veteran move. Subtle enough. And Cooper Kupp, his second touchdown reception of the day.
How tough is that, though, to go one-on-one with that guy?
Tough. So Alcabendis on to add the extra point. And he does. And Eastern Washington cuts back into the lead. And it's just 7, 21-14 with 5:05 to go here in the until halftime.
Some important points right there from EWU.
Nodak
Mutual Insurance replay once again. Gubrud's going to let his playmaker make a play. And he did. And he broke another record in the process. His own.
And Kupp having himself a pretty good day so far, throwing 5 receptions, 62 yards, 2 touchdowns. Beth Houle on the sidelines has a report for us. Beth.
Hey guys, I know a lot of fans of the Bison are not big fans of the Kupp brothers right now, but Cooper Kupp there with career touchdown 61 there. Him and his brother come from quite the line of pedigree. Not only did his grandfather get drafted, but also play in the NFL for the New Orleans Saints, but their mother and their father are inducted into their own college Hall of Fame. Their father playing in football, of course, and their mother playing soccer. Awfully strong pedigree for those two boys.
Yeah, thank you so much, Beth. And that's for Cooper Kupp. Has worked as a counselor at the Manning passing camp because he has that relationship. His grandfather, Jake, was an offensive lineman with the Saints when Archie Manning was there. So there's certainly a relationship there. And this one coming down at about the 8 as Morlock takes it. And Morlock drags the tackler across to about the 26, and that's where the Bison will have it with 5 minutes to go exactly on the clock.
Well, I've driven past Archie Manning's house. Does that count for anything? No, it does not.
That was a pretty big answer there for Eastern Washington. Really was.
I thought those were very important points. And if we're not playing the longest quarter in all of college football, we've got to be pretty close. There's still 5 minutes left. 22 personnel.
Outside run. And here goes Anderson. Flag comes in, and this would be a gain of 9, but I think it's coming back.
There's multiple flags. I think maybe Johnson, and I think maybe Plankers. Pick one. I think they each got caught.
There are two fouls on the play, both on the offense. Illegal block below the waist, offense number 66. That penalty is declined. Illegal block below the waist, number 70. Offense, 15-yard penalty. Replay first down.
That really backs NDSU up now inside their own 14.
Yeah, I saw them both.
The enforcement will be half the distance to the goal line. First down.
I think the Bison would have loved to be able to grind down the last 5 minutes, but you can't do that when you're first in whatever. What, 25, 26 yards probably?
First and 23. Anderson gets the carry and dragging a tackler across the 20-yard line. Gains about 7 yards. And another flag, I think, back at the 7-yard line.
Oh, White Hat's been busy today with flags in his area.
Legal block below the waist, offense number 78. Half the distance to the goal line, first down.
And that backs up the Bison even more.
Well, you can see Leckler right there. Landon's just given that what? Off to the sideline going, I don't think I did what they just said I did.
So now the Bison back to the 6. There's a look at Landon Leckler, the senior out of Beach.
Yeah, Leckler and Johnson in the openers of the offensive linemen graded the best. The coaches felt that those two guys did the best job from that offensive line unit.
First and a mile now for NDSU. They got to get all the way to the 36 for a first down. Power. It's the first time we've seen King Frazier in a while, and he is down at the 12.
Zach Bruce in on another tackle.
So second and 23 coming up as we tick under 4 minutes to go here in the first half.
There's just been some big swings for
momentum.
Each team in this first half.
Back to Power. Pretty good room that time up the middle. As Lance Dunn with another carry gets to the 20.
Well, the Bison looking for a little breathing room, and those two carries did give it to them.
Kurt Calhoun has actually been very, very active as well in the middle. So third and 16 coming up here for NDSU as you take a look at the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Stick will keep it this time. Fires on the out, has an open receiver and caught. First down at the 39-yard line, RJ Erzendowski. And the Bison find a way to overcome a first and 30 and move the chains.
One of the reasons you roll on this play as well, you pull for a little extra protection, but you need time to throw this out, deep out. Little bit of a look-in look from Erzendowski before he squares it out at about the 40 to get the first down. Stick was right on target. He needed the time. He got the time, and his receiver did his job as well. You get open one-on-one.
Big third down there for North Dakota State. And how about Eastern Washington swallowing things up? Samson Abukum comes in to make the tackle at the 40.
Abukum's been a second-team All-Conference player twice. And when you ask the NDSU coaches, who's the best defensive player, or who do you identify as one of the top defensive players, and they said right off the bat, number three. He wore number 91 last year.
13th all-time in sacks. Had two last week against Washington State.
Going against Leckler now.
Stick slips out of a tackle across the 40, and a flag comes in again late. As Stick gets to the 45, but again,
it's a hold.
Might be coming back.
Yeah, yep.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Stick slithers through that one. And here comes the the tackler, who also had to get the flag in there. That's dangerous territory to be multitasking.
Holding, offense number 70. 10-yard penalty, second down.
That's Jack Plankers. And that'll back the Bison up to the 30, and it'll be first and 20. Excuse me, second and 20.
Well, overcoming, you know, how many times can you, during a drive, overcome, you know, penalties that put you so deep? You know, you're second and 20. You needed 30 yards to get a first down at one point. Bison were able to get that. Trying to do it again, very difficult.
And Chris Kleiman will let the clock run down and take a timeout with 1:27 to go.
Timeout, North Dakota State, their first timeout of the half.
And penalties really hurting NDSU now. Seven penalties for 73 yards just in the first half alone. Meanwhile, Eastern Washington has six penalties for 51 yards. Today's game brought to you in crystal clear high definition by Fisher Industries. They take the tough jobs.
Well, penalties certainly were an issue against Georgia Southern, no doubt about that. And that's one of the categories or areas that coaches hope between game one and game two gets cleaned up. Doesn't look like it's working.
Be sure to tune in to Christine Stanwood on the new Fargo CW for Valley News Live at 9 coming up. And there's a look at Christine, who's taken in the game today. So after the timeout, North Dakota State, second and 20. Makes you wonder how much more Tim Polisek's offense can overcome here.
Well, as much as you'd love to kind of sneak some points on before halftime, I don't know how much you're going to expose yourself at this point to try and do it, are you?
Eastern Washington will have the ball coming out of the locker room.
Yeah, the Eagles won the toss. Deferred.
Gubrud so far, 9 of 16 for 134 yards, two touchdowns and an interception. Easton Stick, 7 of 10 for 129 yards and a touchdown.
By rule, the defense had the choice after the previous penalty to have the clock not start until the snap. Please put the game clock back to 1:51. 1:51 on the game clock. North Dakota State will not be charged with that timeout. The clock will start on the snap. It is second down.
And that's that.
So there you go. But in case Eastern does get the ball back, that would give them a few extra seconds. And now, official going to talk over to Bo Baldwin, or at least talk to the linesman on that side of the field. What is the record for longest quarter?
I don't know. Maybe we're setting it.
Oh, boy.
They're going to talk some more. Because Eastern's coaches are still looking for clarification. Maybe as is one of the linesmen on the far side, because he's coming in to talk to the head man.
Well, Bo Baldwin might have even wanted more time put back on the clock. Middle screen. And Dunn ahead to the 38, gets about 9 yards back on that pass play.
Well, you got to point out Zach Bruce again. I thought he closed exceptionally well. Once he made his read, he got rid of the space between him and the ball carrier in a quick hurry.
So third and 12, how aggressive did the Bison offense get here?
I don't know, maybe Polisek will chuck it deep, but it just doesn't feel, it feels like at this point, teams are just trying to crawl to halftime. Doesn't it?
I think the Bison are going to run the clock down here and
use another timeout.
Yeah, they were not charged for that first one, so this is still just their first timeout of the half.
Timeout, North Dakota State, their first timeout of the half. 30-second timeout.
It seems like we've had more conversation than football this quarter, hasn't it? Officials talking to coaches, talking to replay guys.
That's NDSU soccer back in action tomorrow to take on Utah.
Let's take a look at one of our trivia questions brought to you by the North Dakota Soybean Council. Today's question. Today, U.S. corn farmers can produce a bushel of corn. The North Dakota Corn Growers Association question. Today's U.S. corn farmers can produce a bushel of corn using percentage less than 87. What percentage? What do you think, LT?
67.
All right, we'll go with that. We'll have the answer for you here coming up in just a bit.
100% guess.
Stick fires. Dunn makes the catch. And he's across the 50, taken down by Bruce, but he's got a first down to the 48. Boy, Lance Dunn.
Well, he sneaks out of the backfield and beats the linebacker. Does a really good job of being able to get that first down, too. Now the Bison have an opportunity to get a little greedy now that you're in the Eastern's end of the field.
And they'll go quick as Stick goes back to work. Going to air it out, and there's some miscommunication there. As Erzendowski, I think, was the intended target, but his route was broken off at about the 25-yard line.
Yeah, you kind of saw Shepard going loping after it in that direction, but Erzendowski and Stick not on the same page. RJ ran the out. Quarterback read the go.
Answer to your North Dakota Corn Grower Association trivia question. The answer, 37%.
That's what I said, right?
I think you, well.
Oh, no, I said 67. 0 for 1.
That's all right. We're usually pretty good at those. Perkins in motion. Stick going to air it on the other side for Shepard. And he made the catch, but I don't think he made it in bounds. So the Bison taking a couple of shots to the big play wideouts.
But that was,
Shepard was out of bounds.
Yeah, that was a relatively safe shot, though. You're trying to give Shepard the opportunity to make the catch, or you're not giving, you know, the ball back.
The Bison have found a way to keep the chains alive on some of these third and longs, and yet they have another one here, third and 10. Dimitri Williams on the end around. Flag comes in again as he's taken down about 4 yards short of the first down.
Who's that out there? Ilias trying to make the block. Holding. Where's the line? I would decline it and make it fourth down, wouldn't you?
Curious to see if North Dakota State would punt it here on a 4th and 3, 4th and 4, somewhere around there. Find out in a moment here.
Holding offense number 85. 10-yard penalty will be 3rd down. Eastern Washington has chose to start the clock on my ready for play signal.
Okay, so Bo Baldwin will just back up the Bison instead of forcing a punt here. Concern maybe NDSU would go for it and possibly convert.
Yeah, I misread the number. That was Jensen 85, not Ilias 86.
So now the clock starts. Here's a look at the hold.
The Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, right where Williams is turning the corner. You saw a pad kind of go up in the air a little bit there on the linebacker. And we have limped to halftime.
We actually are about a second difference on the play clock. I don't know if it's going to matter.
No. Let's get to halftime.
And they're going to let him go.
At the end of the second quarter.
A wild second quarter comes to an end. North Dakota State does have the lead, 21-14 over Eastern Washington. On what has been kind of a sloppy second quarter that has taken a good chunk of time. Beth Hool.
Hey guys, Coach Kleiman doesn't want to speak.
Beth is not going to catch up with Chris Kleiman here. He's going to head to the locker room and try to get it cleaned up. So we will be back with the Proceed Halftime Report coming up after this on the KVLY KFYR Bison Network. Thanks so much. Brian, Sean, Lee Timmerman here with you. And LT, a very just choppy, uneven first half. The penalty situation got out of control for both teams. When you have 14 accepted penalties and a half, neither team really got into much of a rhythm there.
Now we have a bunch of people going up and down press row like, what's the new rule on the blocking below the waist? And we read it and it confused me even more. So I'm not exactly sure how to interpret what the rule is, but obviously the Bison don't know that either. But it's weird though. I know that, you know, Alex and Ryan just went through a bunch of the stats, but if you'd have said the Bison had 255 total yards at halftime, you'd go, oh, they're playing well. They're not playing well. The other thing that's to me is a little interesting is how balanced the Eagles are. Only one more pass than the run in the first half.
And they really have done a nice job of at least maintaining drives. They've needed every inch to try to move the chains against NDSU, but give them credit. Gubert has hung in there and found the open receiver when they've needed to as well. Take a look at the Bobcats game recap. The penalty is really the big situation. Erzendowski, a couple of catches for 62 yards. And, of course, Cooper Kupp, 2 touchdown receptions, 62 yards total. And the Eagles will have the ball to start the second half here. Simba Webster back once again. Had a long kickoff return, wiped out by a penalty. Nick DeLuca, by the way, really battling that sore shoulder with the dislocation a couple of weeks ago. Had 8 tackles in that first half to lead the team. Robbie Grimsley had 7. Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. There goes Webster. Hit initially, stays on his feet, and then gang tackled at the 19-yard line, and that's where the Eagles will start their first drive of the second half.
Isaac Senazar, first one down for NDSU.
Chris Board also in there to help make the tackle. Gage Gubrud, 9 of 16 in that first half for 134 yards and 2 touchdowns. Take a look at our quarterback comparison brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission. So far, he's done a pretty nice job taking care of the ball, LT, and I know that was a big focus for Eastern Washington coming in.
I know he's been rushed a couple of times, but there's been a couple of times, too, where even against the 3-man rush, he was able to stay patient 5, 6, 7 seconds into the route, find an open receiver on the wide side of the field.
Uber will throw to the inside here to Kendrick Bourne, and Bourne gains 7 up to the 26.
Well, you've watched the Bison over the year, and you know they run that inside power. You call that a bread-and-butter play. Hey, if you're watching EWU, that was a bread-and-butter play. Quick little look on a slant. Boom, we got it. 7 yards on the first down pickup. You're the team in white. You love it.
Jalen Allison in on the coverage there that time. Inside handoff to Jabari Wilson. He has a first down to the 30. Wrapped up by MJ Stump. And Greg Menard also in there to make the tackle.
You know, the two types of offenses that NDSU's have faced so far this year, you asked the Coach Ence, what transfers from Charleston Southern to today? He said, nothing.
Another inside handoff to Wilson. Gains about 4 yards. And Menard making another tackle. We'll bring up 2nd and 6.
That second quarter was just so long and so disjointed that there was absolutely no way for either team to try to get some rhythm. You can tell here for Eastern trying to play a little bit quicker tempo, get in some rhythm. There it is again.
Bourne makes another catch, working inside off Allison. He has a first down up to the 44. So Eastern Washington efficiently moving the chains here.
Here's where the Bison will go to a three-man front now. Get that extra defensive back. That's Bachmeyer comes in and plays safety. Grimsley comes down and becomes the nickel guy. Grimsley was shadowing Cup. Now with the flip of Fields, Cup has a one-on-one on the outside with Allison.
Cup will now motion back to the other side. And Goober going to try to change things up, and now just a timeout on Eastern Washington. They looked confused from the get-go.
Timeout. Eastern Washington, their first timeout of the half. 30-second timeout.
It's a short timeout, but, you know, Bourne starts on the near side. He flips the field. Cup comes over, then goes in motion, and there's a bunch of people trying to figure out what were we supposed to do on this play, and no one figured it out.
There's a look at Matt Entz down there with the headset on. He knew this was going to be a challenge, and we asked him this week, so how fun is it to prepare for a different style team? He goes, I wouldn't use the word fun. But this is an offense that in the Valley, especially with the skill at the position group of wide receiver, that NDSU will see a whole lot this year. I mean, these guys are pretty doggone good.
Yeah, you know, South Dakota State has Winicky and Goddard, you know, the tight end, but the coaches just didn't think that the depth, that Eastern has more depth, more good wide receivers than anyone else they'll face.
Oh, here we go.
Double
Cup is going to throw it. And now Cup is going to try to get away, and he does. And then he stood up and dropped by MJ Stump at the line of scrimmage. So all that ends up no gain. Little razzle-dazzle there. It looked like Cup was looking to hit a receiver downfield again.
Yeah, I tell you, if Rodney Dangerfield was here, it might have been the triple Lindy. You remember that movie? Yeah. Stump puts a pretty good lick on Cup at the tail end of this, and Cooper goes off the field.
For the Eagles!
Stump has him sized up and buried.
Yeah, Cup is shaking up a little bit on the sideline, so they'll go 2nd and 10 without him. Gubru to throw across the middle.
Ooh,
into traffic. Big hit,
great
but
catch.
He hangs on. Nice catch again by Stu Stiles for a first down.
Wow, Mr. Stiles, you earned that one. Bachmeyer put a hard shoulder on him, picked up the first down, and the Bison even put an extra player. So they only rushed two that time, took one of the down linemen, and had him come back and guard. Max protect, but he had some, or max coverage, and he sticks it right over the linebacker, right in front of the safety. Nice job.
Gubrud out to Bourne in the flat, and Bourne slips out of one tackle and then wrapped up by Jalen Allison after a pickup of 5.
Okay, Cup comes back in the game after sitting for a couple of plays. Now the Bison defense expected Eastern to be able to move the ball, which is what the Eagles have done on this drive. But as the field shortens, that's when the defense has to stiffen. The Bison are counting on that.
Gubrud, run pass option, fires across the middle and caught. Another first down for Eastern up to the 25-yard line, and once again, it is Stiles making the catch.
You kind of take advantage of a little bit of the natural flow of the play. So DeLuca reads the rollout, slides out a little bit further. You run the little stick route, you sit down in between, so watch DeLuca clear. There he is off to the right, right in front of Stump. You split the linebackers, well-executed play.
Inside handoff again, and Pierce, the ball carrier this time, picks up pretty good yardage on first down to the 19. We'll bring up 2nd and 4. DeLuca in on another tackle. Good Gubrud slings it to the outside, and this one out of bounds, looking for Shaq Hill. Pressure was on that time as DeLuca and G. Tucker both came.
Yeah, they were coming at him, and he hasn't thrown many poor passes today, but that was one that just did not have a chance to be caught. It was well off the mark and outside.
Eastern Washington just 2 of 6 on third down in that first half. They have a third and manageable here, about 3rd and 4.
Actually, I think the Bison have to feel good just about knocking him down because it's tough to get to the quarterback with this offense. Cup in the slot to the right. No one man head up on him. Here come the Bison.
Slant. And this one is dropped. Incomplete. Shaq Hill, the intended target. And that will bring up fourth down and likely a field goal attempt here for the Eagles.
Well, Coach Entz dials up the pressure. He's bringing them this time. So whatever Gubru decides to do, he knows he does not have much time to do it. Goes to the single coverage side. Wimbush on the coverage.
So Alco Bendis, who's really had to battle back from some knee issues, actually tore up a knee in high school playing soccer, and it's come back to bother him a few times here, but he is the field goal kicker on what is considered the short attempts. This one is up. Looks pretty good, and it is. So Alco Bendis connects from 36. And Eastern Washington trims the lead to 21-17 with 10:58 to go here in the third quarter.
Well, opening drive after you won the toss, you defer, you get the ball, you know you're getting the ball, so you can set your offense up at halftime. Solid drive. Bison have to be happy that it's only 3 points. Eagles very happy that it's some points.
Gubrud, five completions out of 7 attempts on that drive. 12 plays, 62 yards in just under 4 minutes.
You know, other than the obvious points, the thing for Eastern, I think, was probably the best part of that drive, the tempo. They were playing football again, not standing around looking for replays and what's this. Hold on, the coach wants to talk to the ref about this. You know, we just did so much standing around in that second quarter that the Eagles were able to play within the tempo and the pace in which Coach Baldwin wants them to. Now the Bison will have that first opportunity here in the second half after the kickoff.
Bo Baldwin in his 9th season. And Eastern Washington in the last 12 years have had a top 10 passing offense in 10 of them. So they have been an efficient team. Again, they were NAIA as a program until the mid-80s before they came on and went FCS. Really started to become a power in the mid-90s.
I mean, NDSU fans know how tough the Bison early schedule is. I mean, Eastern's is right there. After beating Washington State, you're coming to Fargo, and now you're hosting UNI next week?
Oof.
That's tough.
Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. This one comes down to Bruce Anderson at the 2. Anderson wiggles through one tackle and out to about the 27-yard line.
Brandon Montgomery got just enough of Anderson to take his big momentum away.
Kodak Mutual Insurance replay as we take a look.
31 is the guy you're looking for here for the Eagles. Comes in, coming on your left side right there. Just caught enough of that leg to keep Anderson away from a biggie or a potential biggie.
Anderson just 2 carries, 15 yards running the ball in that first half. Let's take a look at Easton Stick. Quarterback comparison brought to you by the North Dakota Beef Commission. Stick is going to keep it here in the quarterback run game and gets what he can, maybe a yard to the 27. Nice job by Kettner Cup coming in to make the stop. There's a look at Stick's first numbers. 9 completions, 151 yards passing, just 4 rush yards.
Boys had the big one in that dual possession. I think that was the 42-yarder. Mm-hmm. Helped set up a Bison touchdown.
Back to the running game. Lance Dunn sneaking through a hole, and he gets close to a first down, and he might have it up to the 36.
So that to me, like, I believe that was a zone blocking scheme by the Bison. You're not pulling anybody. You're just trying to see what your offensive line can hold up. And then you let the running back, in this case Dunn, pick and get a feel for where the seam was. Good work.
Dunn going to try to bubble outside. Still on his feet. Lance Dunn finally caught up with him as the Eagles swarm him under after a loss of one. And once again, Zach Brusen on another tackle along with Karstetter. Yeah, we have not seen Micaiah Zamora either here today. So, I mean, it's really been some of these backup linebackers, Calhoun, Kettner Cup, and Karstetter, that have gotten a majority of the reps here today.
Well, Karstetter's in that role as a rover, which...
That pass complete to Darius Shepherd, gains about seven up to the 41.
Just a multi-dimensional role with Karstetter, that rover position, because on paper it's a 4-2-5 defensive lineup. But you need somebody to be able to be both a strong safety on plays and maybe an outside linebacker on plays. And that's what number 33 has been doing.
Third and five coming up. Bruce Anderson will motion out. Stick, quarterback draw. Sneaks out of one tackle, and there is the wheels of Easton Stick inside Eastern Washington territory down to the 40-yard line. Gain of 20 on third down, and the Bison move the chains.
When an Eagles player is down back at about the 48, Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, designed run. Olson with a block, Morlock with a really nice block, and now you saw Bruce make a bunch of tackles in the first half coming at, being aggressive toward the Bison, that line of scrimmage. Now he's just... doing that safety, trying to hold on and keep the quarterback from breaking it the rest of the way. I still have not caught the number. Is that?
That might be Samson Abukum.
Is that Abukum? If it is.
Looks like number three on the ground, and that would be a big loss for Eastern, especially if it's serious, because Abukum, one of the more dangerous pass rushers in the Big Sky. This game brought to you in crystal clear, high definition, by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs.
No, I don't think that's a Bukum. No. It's...
Oh, it's Karstetter.
Karstetter. 33, not three. Yeah.
And that doesn't look good. He's not putting any weight on that right foot. There he puts a little bit on. And for a team that's already a little bit thin at linebacker, taking Karstetter off makes it even more challenging.
Well, we just got done talking a moment ago about his position and his job, how multi-dimensional it is in the defensive scheme.
So J.J. Najaku comes in on his place. 5'9 senior out of Tacoma, Washington.
Jeff Schmetting, the defensive coordinator, calling the plays for the Eagles.
Frazier back to the ground game, picks up two to the 38.
Not enough, though. I mean, the Bison want to be when you on schedule, I guess, is one of the way the coaches will say they want to be on schedule. Well, on a first down run of 2 yards, you're not. You're behind the chains already.
Kettner Cup having himself a pretty nice ball game today. Makes another tackle for Eastern Washington.
Kind of funny you're talking about all these rookies or these young players playing for Eastern. They returned at one point all but two starters.
Dunn gets the call, and again, he's swarmed under after a minimal gain of one. Susie Webster came in to make that tackle. Zach Bruce in on another one as well, and that brings up a third and long for the Bison. Kind of in that no man's land right now for NDSU.
In terms of two downs, you mean?
Yes.
Two down territory, yeah.
Play action for Stick. Open receiver across the middle. Darius Shepherd inside the 10. Shepherd! Did he get in? Touchdown!
Shep getting up slow after stretching that one in.
Looks like he might have turned a knee or an ankle there as he got in. Dragging the defensive back. Boy, very close. Might be reviewed.
Again, every scoring play will be reviewed, but it's a matter of were those knees down before the stretch. Well, are they going to let the kick happen, or are we going to continue to look at this one? Still going to look at it. You could make an argument on this one's on the one-yard line.
Ruling on the field is a touchdown. That play is under further review.
So we'll take another look at it.
Well, Shepard's route on that touchdown, he's kind of the shallow cross guy, and then he can take it deep once it's cleared out.
Let's take another look, as the officials do. I think he's in. I'd be tough to overturn it, LT.
We've had a lot of those tough to overturn it type deals.
Here's another look. See where the ankle kind of turned there. Oh, there the knee is down before he extended. So this may come back. That's a pretty good look at it right there to the one.
Yeah. They heard my first guess. I thought you could make an argument that it's on the one. But is it enough?
And another big third down conversion for North Dakota State. Now 7 of 9 today, and they've not been easy conversions.
Oh, been
third and long.
Been very, very, very difficult.
Right there, you see the knee down. Now where is the football? I don't think it's across the goal line at that.
Tough to tell, though, from that angle. If you are the person who has to make that decision to take points off the board.
Yep.
As opposed to the official that is standing three steps away from it.
Shepard again wide open. Coming across
this
the middle.
This may be our best angle at where you think the ball is.
Right there. I think it's coming back, LT.
If it stands, the Bison with a real nice answer.
Yes.
To Eastern's opening drive. Because this is a touchdown and you gave up just the field goal despite the real nice drive that the Eagles had.
And again, North Dakota State getting touchdowns instead of field goals, and that's something I know Tim Polisak talking to us is we got to finish drives when we get in there. We can't settle for threes all the time. There's a look at Shepard, who's trying to run off the ankle twist. One guy that really liked Shepard was Carson Wentz.
Oh yeah.
He's a big fan of this youngster. He's only a sophomore out of Blue Springs, Missouri.
He trusted Shepard to make some really big catches in key situations.
After review, the ruling on the field stands.
Wow. I thought it would come back, but not enough visual evidence to overturn. So North Dakota State keeps the touchdown, and Peterson will like to add the extra point here.
I don't know about you, but I hope we're done with those things.
Reviews?
Yes.
We've had a lot of them.
We've had way too many of them.
Peterson knocks it through. So North Dakota State leads it 28-17 on the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard after a big answer from North Dakota State. A stick by Shepard. We're back to the Fargo Dome after this.
Get your horns out.
Back at the Fargo Dome, sold out crowd. Watching this game in crystal clear high definition. It's brought to you by Fisher Industries. And they like the tough jobs. Simba Webster back deep once again as Peterson gets set for the kickoff. Bison leading by 11. And there's another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season with Peterson Farm Seed. This one going to be returnable, coming down to Shaq Hill at the 6. Hill drilled at the 13-yard line. Wow!
Anderson.
Bruce Anderson like a bullet coming through there to make the stop. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, and watch the green flash come in here. Wow. Beth Hull on the sidelines has a report for us, Beth. Yeah, so Eastern now back to work on offense from their own 15. Bison home crowd coming to life. It looked like somebody jumped, and I think it was number 64, Chris Schlichting, on the offensive line, and that will cost the Eagles five.
Balanced look.
False start. Offense, number 64. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Two receivers to each side, and then the Bison with just a little bit of pre-snap movement on that to come up and try to jam the guy in the slot on the field side. It's a little different look.
Gubrud to throw, and it's Bourne again making the catch. Yeah. Nick DeLuca right on him after a gain of five.
Hill. We got Hill that time.
Excuse me. Shaq Hill made the catch, not Bourne. Look at Jabari Wilson. Six carries, 24 yards for him today out of the backfield. Inside handoff. Five more yards as Wilson is tackled by Nick DeLuca with another tackle and a big third down and about five coming up.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Someone gets a real good hit on, you don't see it on MJ Stump, but an offensive lineman on the linebacker. But Stump gave up his body to make sure that play stayed inside so his middle linebacker could make the tackle.
Four receivers to the high side of the screen here on third and five.
Rushing three.
Gubrud, first read taken away. He might run for it. He's going to air it out. Looking deep downfield. Hill is open. He makes the catch and slips out of a tackle. Shaq Hill, touchdown.
Oh,
a flag back at the 20-yard line to hold everything.
Looked like Winbush gave up a little bit. That play took so long to develop, and it's hard to cover a guy who's that far down, and he allowed a little separation. But, yeah, there is one on the 20 on the near side.
Would be an 80-yard touchdown.
Ineligible
downfield.
Receiver downfield.
Oh,
offense.
Wow.
Number 60. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Jared Jones, the second time he's been called for that today, wipes out an 80-yard touchdown from Gubrud to Shaq Hill. Wow. There's been a lot of big penalty calls today, LT, but maybe none bigger than that one.
Well, that's it. Like you said, that's an 80-yard and a 6-point penalty. I don't know how you're going to get them much bigger than that. A little bit of a, well, a bit, not a little bit. That's a big lucky break there for NDSU. Anytime your opponent has to wipe points off the board, especially on a huge play like that, count your blessings.
So third and 10 coming up. Gubrud back to work, flushed out by Menard. Rolls out, gonna run for it. And he is close, and I think he's got it to the 26.
Almost the 27, yeah. Two steps more than he needed.
Beth Houle on the sidelines has another report for us, Beth.
Hey, guys, let's try this again. Cole Karstetter, you saw him taken off the field there a little bit, number 33. Trainers have confirmed for me it is his Achilles.
Oh, that's bad news.
That's too bad. He was playing pretty well today, too.
Gubrud again. Complete into coverage. Trey Dempsey right on him, but another catch, and boy, a guy that's having a big day today is Stu Stiles.
Yeah, Dempsey's probably going, how did I miss this one? I thought I had it measured. He's the safety. Reads the play, comes up, just couldn't quite get that lead arm, his right arm, to the ball before it. And Stiles did a great job of holding on. He knew once he got both hands on that, they'd be trying to rip it out. Picked up the first.
Gubrud going to wing it downfield into coverage, and it is caught.
Catch.
What a catch. Wow, Kendrick Bourne laid out for it in double coverage and came up with it.
Well, your receiver has to beat the corner, and then the ball has to beat the safety. Both things happened, and on the back end of that, Kendrick Bourne lays out for it.
So Eastern Washington, just like that, down to the 25-yard line of NDSU. Gubru flushed out again, keeping a play alive, and overshoots his intended target. Nick Splendario will bring up second and 10.
Gubru certainly shows that he has a real good feel for things, doesn't he? Just done, as you mentioned, Brian, he's kind of slid out there a little bit, felt the pressure coming. Sometimes you don't even see it, you don't look, you just know it's there. Live to play another down, avoid the sack.
Hubert across the middle, and again it's Styles making the catch. First down up to the 14-yard line.
Yeah, these crossing routes over the middle of the field have been very productive, and Styles is the one who's getting most of the receptions. Here's an ISO on Style. Watch this on the Novak Mutual Insurance replay. It's a zone, so Stump lets him go in front of the safety. Perfect timing. Grimsley can't get there past the linebackers. Well done.
So Eastern threatening, trailing by 11. Gubru, fade pattern. It is caught. Perfect throw and catch. Touchdown.
Incomplete. Didn't have control.
Ooh.
Boy, I thought he had it. And then the ball came rolling out of there.
Shaq Hill, the intended target. It certainly looked like it was a catch. Take a look at the Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
Must not have been, because Hill didn't say anything about it. You know, there he didn't put up any fight. Wow.
Wow.
Well, it came out before he hit the ground, but okay. That was close. That was closer than I thought.
Gubru has all sorts of room to run, and he's going to run. And he scoots around one defender and runs in for a touchdown, 18 yards, and Eastern Washington answers again.
What an outstanding drive. You had an 80-yard touchdown wiped away. You come back, and you score anyway.
Trey Dempsey had the angle initially, but Gubru showing off his athleticism.
That's a dome-quieting drive, isn't it?
Alco Bendis has the extra point, and an 83-yard drive ends with a touchdown for Eastern Washington, and it's 28-24 on the Egg Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. New seed fan cam. Eastern Washington, an impressive drive after having an 80-yard touchdown wiped out. They respond in a big way, taking it in for a touchdown.
Yeah, I mean, it's not that way in the stats, but that was kind of a 165-yard touchdown drive.
It really was. Descalo puts the toe to it, driving Anderson back in his own end zone. Here comes Bruce, tripped up, taken down at the 20.
Bruce.
Pretty good special teams play today by Eastern Washington. Again, Zach Bruce makes the stop.
Well, Bison defense time to answer. Or excuse me, offense. The Bison, my thought process was going to the Bison defense must have got a taste of what Washington State felt a bunch during that game last week.
It was actually, excuse me, not Bruce. It was Tinson Prunty that made the stop today, not Bruce. Nice job defensively.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So now NDSU looking to answer on the offensive side. Stick's going to keep it. Slips out of one tackle and eventually taken down after a gain of 5. Kettner Cup was in there again.
If Stick is able to clear that initial hit just a little bit cleaner, he would have had the first down and maybe a little bit more.
Let's take a look at the Bobcat game recap on that drive. 85 yards in just under 3 minutes. That just shows how quickly Eastern Washington can get to work. 9 plays. Stick will keep it. And complete. Going to be close to a first down as Ilias makes the reception. He might be about a half yard short. J.J. Njoku in to make the stop. Again, he's playing because of the injury to Cole Karstetter.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You saw Ilias able just to kind of look, try to, you know, fool the linebacker into, hey, I'm blocking, and then you slide back out off of that. Picked up 4.5 of those yards.
Warlock the tailback on third and short. He dives ahead and has it across the 30 to the 31.
Wentz goes in motion, comes back, kind of sits up in a good old-fashioned power eye situation. You need a half a yard. You got the line and two blockers ahead of your tailback. You feel every time you should be able to pick up what you need for that first.
Total yardage about even. North Dakota State 338, Eastern Washington 332. Ilias in motion. Stick to throw. Another open receiver. Again, it's Shepard making another catch, picking up 7 to the 39.
One of the biggest parts of football that just goes unseen is all the number of little checks and nuances that go on interior. As Eastern Washington lining first head up on the nose, then going over into the gap, sliding back over, and the offense has to, every time the defensive lineman moves, you have to make an adjustment from that. NDSU did what it needed to do. Nice pickup on first down.
Handoff goes to Lance Dunn. Room on the outside. Now cuts it up. Taken down by Fettig after a first down run to the 43. Amazing how quiet it gets in here when the Bison have the ball on offense. Back to run. Frazier going to bubble it out again. Cannot get away.
Fettig with the tackle.
Now Fettig, another nice open field tackle for a gain of 1. Helmet comes off.
Fettig with a, he had a solid game last week at interception along with 7 tackles. And I know at halftime, I think it was Ryan that mentioned it too, that, you know, the ankle that King Frazier's been dealing with, he didn't practice much 2 weeks ago, hardly at all. So it's kind of the first time in his career here, at least at NDSU, that he's kind of having to deal with an injury.
Stick will throw and complete to the tight end. Nate Jensen has the reception. Good enough for a first down to the 45.
I thought Morlock came up with 1 key block.
That
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay, a crumbing across. There it was. You see it across the face of the quarterback to cut off that rusher and allow Stick the opportunity to hit his tight end.
I think NDSU is going to have to run a play here. The play clock already down to 10. And NDSU needs to get up to the line of scrimmage and run a play.
Should make it.
Morlock tip two through the hole, picks up 4 yards to the 41, and that will be the final play of the third quarter. And yes, it's the fourth quarter, so hold up your 4 because it's the 4 for 4 from PetroServe USA. Get a pizza, 2 cookies, and a drink for $4 at all 24 PetroServe USA locations. We'll be back with the final 15 from Fargo after this.
At the end of the third quarter.
Eastern Washington had some things going. Got some rhythm, made some nice catches, and then, of course, Gubrud with his legs able to take advantage of the open green in front of him and score a touchdown. But you really saw the rhythm. Yep. You really saw the rhythm from Eastern Washington.
But for the Bison in that little montage there, the fact that it was a field goal and not a touchdown, really that's the difference so far on the scoreboard. And, of course, NDSU trying to finish this drive off as well in the end zone.
Back to the ground game. Oh, all sorts of room. Lance Dunn inside the 10. Goodbye. Touchdown. Lance Dunn. 40 yards.
Well, this is how you run the G. Watch the guard when it pulls around, clears out, opens up beautifully. Zach Johnson with the key block. It was open, that hole was open, and Dunn didn't have to do anything but run the truck right through it.
Well blocked.
Perfect. Perfectly blocked. Not well blocked, it was perfect.
And Lance Dunn now nearly to that 100-yard mark at 86 after that run to go along with the touchdown. And North Dakota State leads it by 11, just 7 seconds into the fourth.
There's 66. See the big man right there, Johnson? He was the Missouri Valley Conference Offensive Lineman of the Week. And there he pulls around, seals off that. I love stats for offensive linemen. And when you read the write-up for Johnson when he got the Player of the Week award, 6 knockdowns, 4 pancakes, and 2 decleaters. Offensive linemen don't have many stats, but those are pretty cool ones, aren't they?
That's a pretty good one. So both offenses kind of having their way here in the second half. We'll see if Chris Kleiman's defense can find a way to slow down Gage Gubrud and company.
It is looking like that will be increasingly more difficult to try to do. I mean, but their best receivers probably not coming back. Is that the case?
That's
Cup's got a sprained shoulder.
We have been handed a note that Cup has a sprained shoulder and likely will not return to the game. So that certainly changes things offensively. Now again, they have other players that can make plays. We've seen that with Hill and Bourne, among others, and even Stu Stiles that has played exceptionally well today.
Yeah, but again, this
but
is
Cup
a kid.
Is special.
Yeah, a kid with NFL talents.
Here's another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff, taken at the 8. Hill swallowed up, taken down at the 24-yard line. Isaac Seneskar in there on the tackle, along others.
Morlock, too, I think.
It looked like Chase was in there as well.
There's Cup on the far side. He's got that thing bandaged down.
Well, you can see the frustration. And
well, DeLuca had that in his eyes and in his face 2 weeks ago.
Cup did get married in the offseason, actually had Vernon Adams in his wedding. Those two still very close, even though Adams left to play his senior year at Oregon and now playing in the CFL, along with Bo Levi Mitchell, another former quarterback from Eastern Washington. Hand off to the outside. Cut up, not much, maybe 3 yards to the 28 as Wilson grinds his way. Brad Ambrosius got into that tackle. Tangway at the bottom of the pile as well.
I tell you, you know, Eastern's had success through the year, obviously, but they have been a lot more balanced, run pass, I mean, than I would have guessed so far today. They're nearing, what, mid-20s in rushing attempts?
Mm-hmm. Gubrud caught. Bourne makes another catch.
Lineman down.
Yeah, that looks like Schlichting. Back at the 28, Jalen Allison on the coverage there as 3rd and 2 is upcoming here for the Eagles.
Chris looks like he's holding left shoulder, left arm. He's one of those promising freshmen out of North Bend, Washington, 300-pounder. Yeah, working on left shoulder.
Look at some of the EWU fans who are hoping their team can rally back from 11 down. And Schlichting is up and holding that arm.
Yeah, we just saw the pictures of your All-American wide receiver all bandaged up with a shoulder issue. And it sure looks like Schlichting has a shoulder to deal with as well.
But defensively, Ketch Marchick out with a concussion. Karstetter's out.
Here's 64 coming back to try to hit Menard. Oh, I think he just got locked up and pulled around when Menard was trying to run through. He might have extended when Menard was going through and really put some stress on that joint. Key third down for both teams.
Kubrud flushed, still alive, might run for it, and he's got it. Ball was loose, but Kubrud got back on top of it at the 36, and a first down. Eastern Washington moves the chains again.
I think that goes actually down probably as a fumble and a recovery, too, because of where they kept it.
Moving on the field is a fumble, recovered by the offense. First down.
Kubrud does a nice job at just keeping his eyes and his head downfield, and he's real confident with his feet, too. I like to see that in a quarterback.
Kubrud's going to keep it, and that time the Bison ready for him. Nick DeLuca there, MJ Stumpf there. Gain of two.
Yeah, if you're the quarterback on this run, you're probably thinking, I might be able to fake my way around one guy, but not both of these guys who are the top two tacklers. I'm going to try to keep the punishment at a minimum.
Troy Taylor, the new offensive coordinator here at Eastern Washington. The Bison defensive coaches actually went back and looked at some old high school tape where he was the high school coach. Born. Caught again. Another perfectly thrown ball by Kubrud. Bachmeier was there, so was Allison. But Eastern Washington, another big play through the air. And now Bachmeier can be getting up.
This has been a successful play a couple of times. You count on the receiver to beat the corner, and then the quarterback must beat the safety. And Bourne's been able to make a couple of really nice catches. Of course, he laid out for one, and now the Bison have another player down.
That's Wimbush.
That looks crampish.
Yes.
Now, Bachmeier came off the field, and the Bison have played a bunch of that nickel, and that Bachmeier is the nickel safety, because Grimsley rolls up in that particular instance, and then NDSU went back to the four down three linebackers here when Bachmeier was forced to come off. I think that's a cramp.
He'll have to come out for a play, and that leaves either Darren Kelly or Quentin McCoy to come in and play, and it looks like McCoy is the guy in right now.
And now Board comes in as well with Bachmeier out.
Right.
So that puts Grimsley, that changes Robbie Grimsley's role. Grimsley has to go back and play one of the middle safeties, which Bachmeier was doing. Board will have to come in and be the nickel guy in terms of the person closer, almost in that linebacker role.
And McCoy, a senior JUCO transfer that played mostly on special teams last year.
And Tucker goes out into the slot.
Kubrud flushed. Kubrud still on his feet, and now he goes down all the way back at the 34. Big loss on the play. Ambrosius was in there. So was Tanguay.
Well, Coach Entz felt over the course of the game, rushing three, he would be able to get pressure at times. Ambrosius springs him back around, spins him around, I should say. No place to go. And a huge sack all the way back to the 35.
12-yard loss. Second and 22 coming up. Custer, the tailback, splits to the wide side of the field. Kubrud goes empty. He's going to go for it. He's got a receiver, and it is caught. Touchdown, Eastern Washington. Webster makes the catch.
Remember I talked about how when Bachmeier came out, Grimsley's role had to change because Board came in? Look at who he just beat. He beat Grimsley because Robbie hasn't had to play this position much today. Got the safety, the deep safety, over the top.
Another perfectly thrown ball by Gage Kubrud, and Simba Webster makes the touchdown reception, 35 yards, and Eastern right back into it again. Flag on the field, looks like 11 men, or 12, 12. Men, excuse me, on the field, as Board was on late.
decline it, and it'll run the play.
Helio substitution, 12 men in the formation, defense. That penalty is declined. We will replay the try.
Gage Gubru now 21 of 32 for 319 yards and three touchdowns on the day. And boy, he has thrown the ball in the right spot.
Well, he did it all day last week. Doing it again.
Extra point is added by Alco Bendis. And it's 35-31 on the A Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard. 12 minutes to go from here in Fargo. Today's Eastern Washington, North Dakota State football game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. Another impressive answer for Eastern Washington on second and 22.
Absolutely. Now the Bison offense knows what it has to do, and that's keep scoring touchdowns.
Another Peterson Farm Seed kickoff. Kick off your planting season. Peterson Farm Seed is taken at the six. Anderson working around a block, and Bruce Anderson showing off the speed. And I think a flag is back down at the 35-yard line, so not sure if this will stand or not.
I think we got a block on the back. Zach Wimberly was playing, trying to get into position. I think he was the guy from Eastern who was hit from behind. I did not see initially who hit him.
Eastern Washington looking to become a team that has knocked off North Dakota State at home, and it has not happened often. The Bison 49-4. In their last 53 here at the Fargo Dome.
During the return, holding on the receiving team, number 27. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Isaac Senescar, safety out of Orlando, Florida, will bring the ball back.
Well, I don't think the Bison have lost to a top 10 team since since the championship run started. That in 11, if that's, I think that's right. So yeah, Eastern trying to do something that's very difficult. Again, coming off an FBS win, but NDSU has the ball and the lead.
Throwing 24-yard line. Stick will bring him back out and try to establish the ground game once again, I'm sure. Not much that time. The pile keeps moving. Up to the 27, what looked like maybe a one-yard gain turns into a four-yard gain, excuse me.
Yeah, the initial defense was certainly in position.
Kettner Cup, another tackle.
The big guy's just got an extra three-yard push on this. I think that was Plankers trying to run a little power in there on the pull, and then somewhere in there is a guy with the ball.
Back to the ground again. Lance Dunn picking his way to about the 31-yard line. We'll bring up third and three.
That appeared to be the same play that was popped for the touchdown.
Kettner Cup there again on the tackle.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay again. Dunn trying to get a little something. But there's more, about twice as many white jerseys and green jerseys around the ball.
Inside handoff, and boy, that's going nowhere. Chase Morlock dropped right at the line of scrimmage, and that'll bring up fourth down.
I think Lino was one of the players that was there. Appeared to be a power play inside.
Look at Samson Abukum. Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. And Abukum was the one that
got
Abukum. There.
He was first there. 55 helps him out.
So Jackson Kuntz on for a punt. His first of the second half.
Abukum looked schooled perfectly on that inside power run.
Kuntz in the air. And again, Cup normally the punt returner, but in this situation, he's obviously hurt. And we'll take a timeout. 35-31. Eastern Washington has the ball back at the 35-yard line with 9:44 to go. Take a look at the new seed fan cam. And the fans going to try to give the Bison a little bit of an extra edge here as Eastern Washington goes back to work. Gubrud behind his intended target. Once again, looking for Styles. We'll bring up second and 10.
That was one of the few times I think Gubrud looked like he appeared to get a little bit of a happy feet. He just saw it kind of collapse around him a little bit. Nothing open on the wide side. He checked real quick. Went over the middle right where there were three Bison, and probably pile driving that thing in the turf was about the best thing he could do on that play.
Empty backfield once again. Three-man rush. Menard comes. Intercepted by Nick DeLuca. And DeLuca down the sidelines at the 10-5. Touchdown!
The question of the week. Would Nick DeLuca play? The answer, obviously, yes, and he comes up with the biggest defensive play of the day for North Dakota State.
Bad shoulder and all, DeLuca started holding up the ball a little too soon early. There as Symbol Webster was giving chase.
But Gubrud's done so many nice things today. Boy, he's going to want that one back. He made a misread, threw right into almost triple coverage where two receivers were close to each other. Poor pass.
The extra point is missed. So that makes it a 10-point game instead of 11.
Media timeout.
But a big play for Nick DeLuca on the defensive side. On the Ag Country Farm Credit Services scoreboard, the Bison lead at 41-31. We weren't even sure if Nick DeLuca was going to be able to play today after dislocating his shoulder 2 weeks ago. Well, all he's done is lead the team in tackles with 13 and come up with maybe the biggest play of the game here in the fourth quarter.
Boy, when both offenses are slugging it out, what a huge thing for your team to be able to score on the defense, a defensive touchdown, and not a bigger quick change in the game than that.
Shaq Hill still on his feet.
Oh, great block.
Seneskar giving chase. Shaq Hill still going. Flag comes in, and he's eventually taken down at the 25-yard line by a host of NDSU defenders, including Chris Board. Would have to think that the flag is likely on the return team here.
Personal foul, face mask on the kicking team. 15 yards, first down.
So it will go against NDSU, so that will move the ball up to near the 40-yard line for Eastern Washington.
Yeah, the only strange part about the flag was that when it was thrown, there were no other white shirts
there
in the area with the exception of the runner. Well, your last one was a dud, but you have to load the gun again and keep slinging it if you're that guy.
Quentin McCoy stays on the field as the extra defensive back. This pass complete. Another nice open field tackle on Jabari Wilson by who else? Nick DeLuca.
Boy, he closed well. DeLuca spent a lot of time working on his feet, just trying to improve this part of his game, open field tackling. Not only get there, but get there in position, use his strength to bring him down. That's why the NFL knows who number 49 is.
Gubrud back to work again. Plenty of time across the middle. Bourne, who hangs on and took a huge shot. Or was that Styles?
Styles again.
Styles is the one that took the big hit.
He has
made the catch.
He's done the dirty work over the middle. This time he made the catch again and paid for it. But boy, Styles has been money in between the hash marks, and now he's laying right on top of the hash marks. Grimsley, Robbie Grimsley comes over, puts a shoulder in him. right after the catch. Good hit, though. Led with his shoulders. There was no helmets, no spearing, none of that type of stuff.
Oh, there's a flag out, LT.
No, this was not a spear or led with his helmet deal. I do not believe that he hit him high. He hit him in mid-chest.
A flag has been thrown, so
this
we'll see.
This is now a reviewable play this year, which in the past it has not been. I thought that was well done by the defender.
Personal foul, targeting.
No.
On the defense, number 5.
Absolutely not.
15-yard penalty, automatic first down. That play is under further review.
No. So they are reviewing it, which is a good thing, because I don't think that this will stay.
And this is new this year, that you can review this play and this call.
The penalty has not been marked off yet. Well, the fan base doesn't like it. We know that.
I don't like it either. He didn't launch. Didn't lead. Shoulder was at the chest. That's where the ball was.
So they continue to look at it upstairs and deliver the verdict to the white hat.
You didn't think it was, did you?
I don't. I think it looked worse in real time than what it really was when you slow it down and look at it. If that is targeting LT, I don't know how you play safety.
you got to let the defensive player have the opportunity to do his job. Arms were even down. I mean, he wasn't up, wasn't trying to take an extra cheap shot at the head.
That being said, with all the reviews, nothing's been overturned today. So you just don't know. If the penalty is enforced, Eastern Washington would get the ball at the 22 of NDSU. If not, they keep it at the 37. But more importantly, Robbie Grimsley
would have to be gone
from the game.
And the following quarter.
Yep.
Or following half.
Yeah, so that means they'd miss him the first half at Iowa.
If I understand that correctly.
The result of the play is the completion. After further review, the ruling of targeting on the field has been reversed. Yeah! Number 5 may remain in the game. Number 5 may remain in the game. There is no yardage penalty. It will be first down at the spot of the catch.
Last year, that would not have happened. Grimsley would have been gone immediately. And then I think you could have appealed maybe for your next half. But replay gets this one right.
So it is a completion. It is a first down. Eastern Washington keeps the ball, but they just don't get it at the 22.
Don't discount how big a catch that was, because that was a huge catch for the Eagles.
Goober looks to the sideline. Now NDSU trying to check off. The volume picking up here. Play clock down to 7.
See if DeLuca comes. He does.
Gubrud hangs on to it, sneaks away.
Oh, that's
he is
close.
Ripped out of bounds by Caleb Butler. Nice pursuit after a gain of 3. Beth Houle on the sidelines has another report for us. Beth.
Hey, guys, I'm on the sideline with our pregame show co-host Ryan Gellner, who actually said in our pregame show they talked about a new rule this year where a targeting call can be thrown from the booth. And that's a decision new this year that the officials in the booth in the replay can make that call themselves and then call for the review to qualify it.
All right, thank you, Beth. Three down lineman again for the Bison, and this one whistled dead.
Bison timeout.
Before the snap, timeout, North Dakota State. Their first timeout of the half. 30-second timeout.
So the Bison take a timeout to try to get things organized defensively.
Game clock operator, please set the game clock to 7:58. 7:58 on the game clock.
Something in the formation or the defensive call at the time that Coach Entz or Coach Kleiman or somebody up top did not like.
There's a look at Coach Matt Entz in his third year as defensive coordinator here at NDSU. We talked to him this week. He said, you know, we've never really done anything like we're going to do today. I mean, we've really had to tailor this defensive game plan to this opponent because of the challenges they present to us. We know we just can't play base all day.
No, and it's a combination at times, you know, press cover, man-to-man with some zone. There's been some total zone in it where the Bison have been beat on some deep corner or some deep routes over the top. That time he dialed up the pressure, brought DeLuca on a blitz. Now it's four down linemen, so another different look here from NDSU.
Four come, Gubarud, pocket collapses, he escapes again. Gubarud to the end zone, it is caught! Touchdown, Styles makes another play, and Gubarud continuing to make plays with his feet and find open receivers downfield, and Eastern Washington just like that back within four.
That is a beautiful job by the quarterback. He gets out of the pressure. You would have sworn it was going to be a sack. And then when he looks downfield backside. So that's obviously something that is just a predetermined setup. When we scramble, we're going to scramble long. And if I think I have enough time, I'm going to scramble backside long. And he delivered it before the Bison defense could get there. That's a sweet touchdown.
Alco Bendis missed the extra point. So each kicker now has missed an extra point, and the lead remains four. On the Egg Country Farm Credit Media Services scoreboard, the Bison still lead it 41-37, just under 8 minutes to go. Back at the Fargo Dome, this game brought to you in high definition by Fisher Industries. They like the tough jobs. And Eastern Washington, just when you think maybe the Bison have the momentum and will pull away, answer the bell once again, and Gubarud with his feet has been so dangerous today.
Correct, but you missed the extra point. You took away, you know, when you miss an extra point, you almost cursed that the whole game. Well, the Bison missed one, Eastern gave it right back to him.
And this one kicked away from Anderson will go through the end zone out of bounds, and the Bison will start at the 25.
And if you can't be done scoring on the offensive side, if they're not, I don't think we're going to stay at this margin right here.
Take a look at our North Dakota Corn Growers Association. Trivia question, how many gallons of ethanol are produced from one bushel of corn? There are some answers to take a look at. We'll have the answer coming up for you here in just a bit. So Easton Stick brings the offense back out. Outside run to Anderson. Oh, and he is swallowed up. And nice job defensively again by the young corner, Jake Hoffman came up to make that stop.
Well, a little pin and pull there from the Bison, taking Volson the center. He snaps, pulls, near side guard also pulls to try to get out there. But there was no one to block because the defender made a nice read and beat both of those big guys to the point of the attack. That was well done.
So that backs up the Bison now to their own 21. They need the 35 for a first down. Anderson in motion. Stick to throw, tipped, and it is incomplete. Shepherd the intended target. Dangerous throw there by Easton Stick. And a nice job up defensively by Kirk Calhoun to get his hand up in the air to deflect that pass.
Well, the deep drop by the linebacker makes the difference. I thought initially this was the right read. When Anderson motions to the side, as you're looking that off to the left, that helps open up the seam because everyone has to make an adjustment to the outside. Right up the hash mark, but linebacker drop does his job. I did think that was the right place to go with it, though.
Third and 14. Stick play action. Flushed out. Not going to get away. And taken down at the line of scrimmage for no gain. And a three and out for North Dakota State as Eastern Washington stiffens up defensively once again. And it's Calhoun on the stop.
Yeah, and the loss on the play means that your punt returner is going to get this ball on an even shorter field.
Jackson Koontz back out for another punt here for NDSU.
Short
punt. High, but not very deep. Touchdown at the 47-yard line. So Eastern Washington on a very short field after only a 32-yard punt.
But this is where the difference between the missed extra point really plays huge. You know, because you're you need to gain the lead, obviously you need the touchdown. But if you're 3 points behind on the road, you're thinking, hey, maybe if we can get three out of this and we got it tied up.
Take a look at the answer to our North Dakota Corn Growers Association trivia question. How many gallons of ethanol produced from one bushel of corn? The answer is 2.8. So back to work. Gage Gubru, 378 yards passing so far here today. Handoff goes to Pierce. To Mark Pierce. Picks up about five inside NDSU territory to the 49.
But for a moment, it looked like Pierce was going to maybe gain another three or four or more after that because Stump just kind of missed the tackle. He whiffed just a little bit, kept his feet. I thought he was maybe going to break it bigger than he did.
This will be the 66th play now for Eastern Washington today. Gubrud under pressure, and he is
Menard
taken down by Greg Menard at midfield. Just a loss of one, but another all-important third down coming up for Eastern Washington today. They are 4 of 9 so far.
Keep in mind, too, Menard is going head up against the new guy because Schlichting went out with that injury. Menard just beat him on around the edge, and Gubru's been so good today at feeling or sensing that pressure. He did not see Menard on that particular play. He got the corner and got to the quarterback.
Gubrud. Flushed out of the pocket, going deep as Stiles open.
Caught it.
Caught it in double coverage again. Stu Stiles comes up with it all the way down to the 13.
Well, you can't say that man can't catch the ball in traffic because he got blasted on that one by Grimsley. Tucker trying to play catch up. Grimsley coming over to try to help out. And he pulls down another huge catch.
And NDSU has no answers for Gage Gubrud and some of the plays he's making in the pocket. Gubrud will run. It opens up Gubrud to the end zone, and he is down at the 1. Robbie Grimsley makes the touchdown saving tackle.
Another good decision. Get what you can. He has done a good job today of doing that.
Inside handoff goes to Pierce, and Eastern Washington has the lead back in quick fashion. They go right down the field and have taken the lead 43-41. Wow. The true freshman puts the Eagles ahead.
Well, the guy who hands it off is the reason for this go-ahead touchdown, because Gubrud again with that long pass over the middle. I know he did get sacked on that one. Ran it down to the 1. Helps set up his team. He has been impressive today. Movement on the right side.
Ball start. offense number 60. 5-yard penalty, replay the try.
Alco Bendis back out there to attempt another point after.
Injury? Injury timeout.
It's like Grimsley. Right arm. So Board comes in.
And the Bison are running out of safeties. Bachmeyer's missed time. Now Grimsley's coming off.
So Alka Bendis will look to extend the lead to 3. And this time he puts it through. Eastern Washington leads at 44-41. 4.5 minutes to go. Can NDSU find the answer late and come up with enough plays to pull one out here at home? Gage Gubru today, 25 of 38 for 415 yards, 4 touchdowns.
He's obviously been sacked, so his rushing yardage isn't going to be that great, but he's been really good with his feet today, too.
Again, this is a guy that was a walk-on. He was not really recruited by any Division I schools, offered by a ton of D2s. And all he's done is come in here as a sophomore, win the starting job, one of the most prolific passing offenses in the country.
I mean, Linfield's been one of the best NAI programs around for a long, long time, and he grew up in the shadow of Linfield College. But he felt in his heart and in his mind that he wanted to play Division I. You mentioned the walk-on. He walked on. And then not only did he walk on, but he walked on and he was the last quarterback on the roster. So he, in the matter of 2 years, has moved his way from dead last into beating Washington State last week and attempting to beat the number one team in the country this week.
Descalo puts the toe to it. Anderson from his own one. Anderson picking his way. And a flag comes in late once again. NDSU has been penalized 10 times for 108 yards, and this may be their 11th penalty.
Must be a hold, because after he threw the flag, he moved it, because then you mark the penalty from where the, or you mark it off from where the penalty happened, and that's where the flag comes
during
in.
During the return, illegal block in the back, return team number 37. 10 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
Trey Fort, the Shanley product. We'll back the Bison up inside their own 20.
Well, look at the last, where the Bison have started in their last couple of drives, the 3-and-out. They lost some yardage, had to punt. Long field Bison, short field Eastern. In the last, what's that, four possessions, I believe?
Done on the end around, has a block to the outside, working off of it. And another flag comes in late at about the 36.
And this came from the back judge.
Right now, it would be a 10-yard gain and close to a first down, but he may back it up. Stu Stiles, by the way, previous highs for games, catches, and yardage.
But he's blown
that
away.
3 for 30.
Yeah.
Last year against Sacramento.
Holy cow. What's he got now?
He has 7 receptions in his career coming into today.
Illegal block below the waist. Offense number 20. Half the distance to the goal line from the spot of for the end of the run. Half the distance. Replay first down.
Let's take a look here on the Notre Dame Mutual Insurance replay. That's Shepard.
And he's below the downfield below the waist.
So that'll back him up all the way to the 14. First and 14.
You have to engage above the waist. If you slip down after that, so be it. But your initial contact must be above.
Yeah, Stiles today, 8 receptions, 169 yards and a touchdown. Man.
And some tough, tough catches.
Outside handoff again. Njoku gives chase. Anderson around the corner, keeps his feet, and out of bounds right around the 20-yard line. So that'll bring up 2nd and 8. Rondo Tucker coming in, and Eastern Washington has rotated a lot of different defensive backs in here today.
Here's your Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. You're hoping Shepard can clear his guy a little bit. He couldn't quite do that. Anderson had to run a little too far sideways. Just a hair contact toward the end, but nothing there.
Stick, quarterback draw. Ran his own man, Jack Plankers, and that will bring up third and three. Third and two, maybe, the 26.
Spread him out to run it. Stick's trying to avoid Cup, so he sees that and moves off to his left where he runs into his own guy. If he's able to clear that contact, it's a first down.
Big third down here for North Dakota State with 3 minutes to go here in the football game. Stick to throw, and this one is complete. Big third down conversion for the Bison.
Freeman.
Dallas Freeman making his first catch of the day, and boy, a big spot for it right there, up to the 35.
Freeman's in the middle, three receivers on the far side. He's the guy in the middle. Stick on your Nodak Mutual Insurance replay. Quick setup and fire. And a very important first down for the Bison.
Ticking down towards 2.5 to go here in the football game. Somebody might have moved there for North Dakota State. False start, moving back five.
False start, offense, number 70. 5 yard penalty, first down.
Yeah, first and Plankers.
First and 15 again. That's happened a lot today.
And now time becoming a factor as well. NDSU two timeouts, but time continues to tick away here. Stick's gonna run. Got one block, and then forced out of bounds by Zach Bruce after a pickup of four at the 34.
Maybe just that time element, that the major thing here is that he does get out after the 4 yard gain. Johnson getting a little bit of a block, but not enough there to spring it.
Yeah. Now the clock starts again.
Oh, I thought he did get out, I guess. Wow.
Under two to go. Done. Up the middle. Gains three up to the 37. And NDSU will take a timeout.
Timeout. North Dakota State. Their second timeout of the half. 32nd timeout.
Obviously two down territory here for North Dakota State with time running out.
This will be a full timeout. Full 60-second timeout.
Yeah, I don't know if you saw that, but Coach Kleiman went out there waving his arms wide, just telling the official that we want the extra time on this one.
Game clock operator, please put 1:48 on the game clock. 1:48 on the game clock. Thank you.
A field goal would tie it, obviously. And the Bison hopes at least to get to that point. Could we have back-to-back overtime games in Fargo?
Right now, the Bison might take that option if you give it to them. Double tight. Wide receiver in slot to the field side. With the lone setback.
Third and nine from the 36.
Feels like a play to Ilias to me.
Pressure comes across the middle, caught. First down to the 45-yard line. And it's the other tight end. Nate Jensen, that comes up with the reception.
Well, I was guessing tight end. I just guessed the wrong number. I was only one off, 85 and 86. But it just seemed like the two wide guys off to your left were more decoys to let the tight ends make a move.
So the Bison move the chains now in Eastern Washington territory.
Big first down.
Stick to throw again. Now flushed. On the run. And complete to Darius Shepherd. A dangerous pass, but complete for another first down to the 31.
It was dangerous, yes. But you're in gamble mode. You have to try to make things happen. Jake Hoffman came in to try to make the play. Number 17 flies right past it. Shepherd works his way back to his quarterback, sets down, gets the first.
Under 120 to go. Stick to throw again. And this one into coverage, into traffic, incomplete.
Hoffman again. This time he was able to get to the football before it got to the receiver. He was close in the last two plays.
Dallas Freeman, the intended target. Vincent Gamboa also in there for Eastern Washington. Can the Eagle defense come up with a stop here? Stick gonna run. Down to the 24-yard line. Nice gain of close to 8 yards. We'll set up a third and short. JT Tiuli slow getting up for Eastern Washington. That will stop the clock momentarily.
No, I think the Bison used their last time out.
Timeout. Okay. North Dakota State.
Yep.
Their final timeout of the half. Please set the game clock to 1:02. 1:02 on the game clock.
From here, you're looking at about a 41-yard field goal for Cam Peterson. But I'm sure Tim Polasek would like to get the first down and try to get more yardage here in this drive. Zach Bruce, along with Kurt Calhoun, had really good games today for Eastern Washington. 14 tackles for Bruce, 13 for Calhoun. The Bison offense, all in all, you have to be pretty impressed. They put up 257 passing yards and 232 rushing yards for almost 500. And the Bison will spread it out here, five wide. On third and short.
Well, Stick's going to count his numbers in the box and see if he likes the numbers on whether it's going to be the quarterback run or the pass play. There, he just made his call.
Stick's going to run, and he's got room. Easton Stick down to the 11-yard line. Good enough for a first down, and the Bison now under a minute to go. No timeouts. We'll have to go quickly.
But plenty of time to take some shots. No doubt about it. You're only 11 yards out.
And Stick will clock it with 53 seconds to go.
Here's Stick's first down run. Ooh, fantastic job inside. I think that was Johnson again. Got the Bison to the position they are now at the 11.
They're going to reset the play clock to 25 here.
So man-to-man press on all three receivers. Freeman looks like he's got a good one-on-one.
Oh, and Freeman was open, but it was behind him. So that will bring up third and 10 from the 11.
Freeman got into the end zone and tried to make an adjustment back, but the pass was too far wide. Now Erzendowski has the man up top. He's single. Well, Shepherd's going to motion into it. Okay.
Stick to throw to the end zone through the hands of his intended target, Jeff Ilias, and incomplete. So now Peterson will have to come on here and attempt a field goal to tie the football game. Will be about 28 yards from here.
There was the ISO shot on Ilias. Ball just got to him a little bit too quick, maybe. Fisher the snapper, Davis the holder.
Peterson from 28 to tie it up. It is up, and it is good. So Peterson delivers with 42 seconds to go, and we're all tied at 44. But Eastern can strike quickly, and they do have two timeouts.
Even without your All-American wide receiver, they've been able to get the ball downfield successfully.
Both teams now over 500 yards of offense today.
Yeah, when you're the team on the road at Eastern like this in the position, I would think you take every chance you can in these last 42 seconds to try to avoid overtime.
Well, it took over 20 years to get your first ever overtime game in the Fargo Dome.
That's right. And we're 42 seconds away from back-to-back.
To figure after a return, Gubrud might have around 30, 35 seconds left to move the ball downfield.
Both teams at times have really done a nice job on third down, haven't they?
Yeah, they really have.
In some key moments.
And frankly, Eastern Washington has not had that many third downs that they've had to go for. They've been able to do a lot of their damage early on first and second down. Special teams will have to try to hold on here and not give too good a field position to Eastern, but this is a short kick to Shaq Hill. Hill to the sideline, down to about the 29-yard line.
First hit by Plank, and then I think Perkins came in to finish the tackle.
So 36 seconds for Gubru to work with, and two timeouts. If it is a long field goal attempt from 40-plus. Yeah,
a couple different kickers, don't they?
Expect Descalo, the punter, to be the kicker for that situation. He was one of two last week. He's 4 of 5 in his career.
Gubrud knows that he wants to be aggressive, but he obviously does not want to make a mistake either.
Gubrud swallowed up back at the 25-yard line, and the Bison finally get there. It's taken all game long, but Brad Ambrosius makes the sack, and Eastern Washington will call a timeout.
I think that goes back to what I just said there, Brian, though. He did not want to force anything. He didn't have it, didn't have a clean shot of it.
Timeout.
He's going to eat it.
Eastern Washington, their second timeout of the half. Please put 28 seconds on the game clock. 28 seconds.
So still some time to work with here if you're Eastern Washington. But again, how aggressive do you get?
Thank you.
You know, if nothing else, if you're Eastern, why not go back to those deep balls down the sidelines that have, you know, it's relatively, you know, low risk, high reward. Those plays have been hit a couple of times so far today. Put it in a place where your guy catches it or nobody catches it. Or throw it over the middle, let Styles catch it and get drilled again.
Bachmeyer in at safety, and Robbie Grimsley dinged up on the sidelines. Gubrud stepping up. Now he's going to run, and he's hit and taken down after a gain of about 4, and another timeout for Eastern Washington with 21 seconds to go.
Timeout. Eastern Washington, their third timeout of the half. 30 seconds.
Caleb Butler came back along with MJ Stumpf to make that tackle.
Seemed like when Gubru was starting to shuffle up in the pocket, he was looking off to his right, but there was no separation out there. There were two receivers, one trying deep, but he was bracketed by the Bison both on the man guy and the guy over the top, so he did not force anything over the top.
So third down upcoming here for Eastern Washington. And again, They have to think at least the 35-yard line of NDSU to give themselves a realistic chance at a field goal.
That's still a monster, though. That's still a 50-plus.
Yep.
Played it safe on the first two downs of this possession. Let's see how aggressive Goodwood gets here.
He's going to take a shot. He's got a receiver, and it is caught. Splendorio makes the catch all the way down to the 32. And we're down to 13 seconds left.
That's what we were talking about outside, and he got single coverage, no safety help on the wide side. That was the perfect read, and it connected.
So the clock starts, and it will be spiked with 10 seconds left. And here comes Descalo. Neither team with any timeouts. Will be about a 49-yard attempt.
And this is a much further kick, but the last time the Bison got beat in this building, what did they get beat on? Game-ending field goal.
Miles Bergner from South Dakota last October.
Almost.
Charleston Southern had this exact same scenario 2 weeks ago. The field goal was missed. It is up. It's wobbly. It is no good.
Charleston Southern missed. Wide left. This one also goes left.
And the Bison and the fans holding their breath hang on to play another down.
Boy, Allison coming off the field a little slow. This defense is gassed. They've been put to the test today big time. That's been a lot of snaps that the Bison defense has played.
And that coming off of Descalo's foot did not look good at all.
Never got that end over end.
Boy, Grubrud continues to just rack up the yardage now. 450 yards through the air. 26 completions, 39 attempts. Oh, boy.
Tried to pitch it.
Oh, boy. Is there time on the clock? No, there is not.
They're done. Okay. There's no chance for a field goal. That was the last play. Frazier tried to pitch it and do the
backwards
thing.
That is the end of the fourth
thing.
Quarter.
So, in back-to-back games here in Fargo, we are headed to overtime. Tied at 44.
They'll go out and they'll flip the coin again.
And this game almost 4 hours long already.
Please set the game clock to 3 minutes and wind the clock.
Lance Dunn, 13 carries, 103 yards. The Bison do have 245 rush yards today.
Well, let's set up the overtime scenario just in case people don't know what the college overtime rule is. You know, it's the ball at the 25, so you can get first downs. And then it's similar to the high school in that if you score first, the other team has an opportunity to match that score or go ahead.
In this scenario 2 weeks ago, North Dakota State actually lost the toss, had the ball first.
And Frazier scored right away.
On the first play of overtime. Then that forced Charleston Southern to come back and try to score. Four plays, they did not move it a yard, and that was it. We'll go ahead and take a quick timeout. 44-44, back with overtime from here at the Fargo Dome after this. Back at the Fargo Dome, North Dakota State has won the toss.
And you always go on defense. Because you want to know what you need to do.
Exactly.
And then Eastern will choose which end of the field.
Which
inside makes no difference. Yep.
North Dakota State won the coin toss, chose to go on defense first. It will be first down, Eastern Washington.
Well, it's been a crazy game, and here's part of the craziness.
It's Nate Jensen making a big third down reception on that last drive, and then Easton Stick using his legs to get the Bison in field goal range, LT.
And that set up Peterson, knocking it through, and it's 44-44. And then Eastern Washington comes down with a big pass completion and one last chance to win the game, and that one did not have a chance. That's why we're in overtime for the second game in a row.
It's been fun. Hope you folks have enjoyed it, whether you're watching back in the Eastern Washington area in Spokane, in Cheney and other areas, or watch us statewide here on NBC North Dakota Sports or wherever you are on ESPN3. Thanks for tuning in. It's been a wild one.
Yeah, we were talking with, you know, Dave Cook beforehand, and it's like, who's all seeing this out west? And they said from Yakima all the way in the eastern part of the state.
So Eastern Washington has the ball first.
Pressure.
Gubru keeps it, and he is swallowed up back at the 32-yard line by MJ Stump.
Well, you knew Matt Entz, the defensive coordinator, sometime had to go for it. He does it on the first play in the overtime. Go for it, I mean blitz. And they both came. Stump came, DeLuca came. MJ was clear, and he knocks him for the 5-yard loss.
So Eastern back to work. Second and 15 from the 30. Gubru to high across the middle.
Intercepted.
Trey Dempsey come up with it.
Yep. He picked it.
He did. With one hand. And the Bison defense comes up with a stop, we think.
They'll look at it again. But I thought he picked it clean. We'll look at this.
Early on the field is an intercepted pass.
Nodak Mutual Insurance replay.
I think he got it.
First down.
Oh, yeah, he got it.
State.
One hand, the right hand comes out. Ball never comes to the turf. Has control underneath it. Both hands on the ball.
Yeah, that's an interception.
You'll have to look at it. Here's probably a better look just to see that left hand get back underneath it. No point of the ball on the turf. INT.
The Lakeland Dreadnought from down in Florida. A quarterback from down there, Holden Hotchkiss, has committed to come to North Dakota State next year. And Trey kind of paved that way from Lakeland.
The previous play is under further review.
And they will take a look at it, but I'm sure they'll see exactly what we saw.
Of course, when the defense does what it just did, any score from NDSU wins the game. Touchdown, field goal, what have you.
You'd think the Bison will want to pick up some yardage at least here to make this easier on Peterson.
Well, I think you try to grind it in. If you're the offense, you want to score the touchdown and not give your kicker, leave it into the hands of your kicker.
The third interception of the day for Gubru, who overall has had a really good day, but he really misfired on that.
Yeah, he's been fantastic, but that one, that was a whiff.
And again, they have done this all in the second half in overtime without Cooper Kupp, who's on the sideline with his arm in a sling, iced up.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the replay will confirm the call on the field.
When I first saw it, LT, I didn't think there was any way he could possibly bring that thing in because his body was going the other way and he just kind of stuck his arm out. But
I thought in initial play, I thought he got it.
There's a look at Bo Baldwin. He's been a part of some big games in the Big Sky and NCAA tournament over the years, but this one right up there with one of the best. Yeah, nothing easy for Eastern Washington either. Now they get to host Northern Iowa at home, who's playing Montana today, and the Bison
play another
go to
team
Iowa.
From Iowa. Some other team from Iowa. Which one could that be?
A nationally ranked opponent.
View the ruling on the field of an interception stands. First down, North Dakota State.
So NDSU here will try to grind out some yards and find a way to put Eastern Washington away finally here at home.
I would assume Dunn or Stick will get the carry.
To the power game. Dunn to the outside. Inside the 10. Lance Dunn. Bison win.
Here's your replay. Dunn with a little hesitation move. You beat the safety. Good downfield block there from Freeman. And one play, touchdown. Last week, one play, touchdown in overtime.
Last week, 2 weeks ago, was Frazier. This week, it's Dunn, who ends up with 128 yards rushing on 14 attempts and two touchdowns. And North Dakota State escapes with another overtime victory at home, 50-44. My goodness.
Well, you knew against Eastern, you're going to have to put some points on the board. And the Bison did. And the biggest touchdown was scored by a defensive player today, I think.
Nick DeLuca, the pick six, bum shoulder and all. Really got it done, and the offense made the plays when they needed to. North Dakota State survives.
Yep. Dempsey with the interception. Dunn with the touchdown. Game over.
And
sure
Eastern
took
Washington.
A long time to get to that point.
Oh, boy.
And a lot of wild craziness in between.
And after a heartbreaking overtime loss at Roos Field in 2010, North Dakota State in overtime finds a way to win here at their home field turf. Unreal. Beth Rule will try to catch a word here with Chris Kleiman coming off the field.
Coach is getting close to her. What a game by DeLuca again, though, too. Wow.
And now Beth Rule has Coach Kleiman.
Another overtime game. You guys came out on top again. What's going through your head right now?
Well, just a bunch of resilient guys. That's a great football team we played, and so proud of our guys for kind of staying the course. And we knew it was going to be a back and forth game. And ultimately, we got the stop that we needed on defense. What a great play by Trey. And then I think we finally wore him down running the power play.
You were busy at halftime and ready to get in that locker room. What was the message at half? What did you guys say to come out in that second half and push all the way through another overtime?
Well, we can't worry about other things that happen on the field, and that's partly on me, too. We can't worry about it. We control what we can control, and that was my main message. I didn't mean to leave you, Beth.
Oh, no, you're fine.
Don't hate me on that,
Beth. I won't.
But no, we have to control what we can control, and that's me as well, and it's a good learning experience for us.
Thanks, Coach. Congratulations on the win. Guys, back to you.
Beth, thanks so much, and there's a look at Cooper Kupp. Disappointed Eastern Washington didn't win. Equally as disappointed, probably he didn't get a chance to play in the second half or overtime. But give credit, some other guys really stepped up in his place. Really, namely, Stu Stiles was the guy to me that was unbelievable.
Stiles was fantastic. The catches he made in traffic gave his team the opportunity to win. But, boy, the Bison made the plays when needed to get the game to overtime. And then once they got to overtime, obviously, Dempsey and Dunn, bang, bang, the 1-2 punch.
Well, LT and I will take a breath. Get a water, perhaps, Gatorade if there's one around here, and be back here to wrap things up from the Fargo Dome. You're watching the KBOY KFYR Bison Network. The sold-out crowd filing out here at the Fargo Dome after another great football game between two excellent programs here in the FCS, and the fans have been treated to two really good ones to start off this 2016 season. Well, our Nodak Mutual Insurance Player of the Game, is none other than Nick DeLuca, who came out here after dislocating his shoulder 2 weeks ago, had 14 tackles and a big pick six that really was the difference in the game.
Well, I thought it was. That's the biggest play for NDSU. Here's DeLuca finishing this off. He almost raises it a little too early before he gets in, but he does get in. He also had 7 solo tackles out of those 14. So DeLuca's presence helped make the difference for a Bison defense that was on the field for 75 plays. And the Bison offense ran 74 plays.
Wow.
That's why it's almost 7 o'clock.
And total yardage, by the way, for Crazy. Eastern Washington, 556 mm-hmm. for the Bison, 537. So very even across the board as these two teams meet up. But who knows, maybe we'll see them again in December or January. That's how excellent of a game this really was. We'll be back here after another quick timeout on the KBLY KFYR Bison Network to wrap things up. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you in a bit. Back at the Fargo Dome to wrap things up, North Dakota State 50-44, your victors over a really resilient Eastern Washington team that came up with a lot of plays despite a ton of injuries today. As we look at our stat report brought to you by the North Dakota Certified Seed Producers, and boy, a lot of big numbers on that screen, LT.
Yeah, stat keepers were very, very busy. I mean, there's we're close to 100 points scored, over 1,000 total yards, 537 to 556. Gubru, again, was fantastic with 450 passing. He did make a couple of mistakes. He made the mistake on the pick, both of his interceptions, I guess, kind of hurt his team, but he did so many good things today. But the Bison always kind of pride themselves as being a rushing team, 280 on the ground.
Absolutely, and the time of possession, not as heavily in favor of North Dakota State as we're used to seeing, but give credit to Eastern Washington. They made the plays, especially on third down, to keep their team on the field. For Eastern, really depleted, especially on defense, with a lot of guys going out. Cooper Kupp, we talked about that, him going out. But, boy, a lot of guys stepped in and made plays. And you have to figure in the Big Sky, this team's going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Boy, I think they look pretty good. And that's traditionally more of a wide-open type of a style of play, which obviously what we saw today, what we heard about, and some people saw against Washington State in a win, they look like a team that has no problem with putting the points on the board, and they'll try to outscore you later down the year. And when you talk down the year, this could be a very, very important win for NDSU because strength of schedule, remember, plays a bigger role now into potential playoff seedings and where you may play. And now the Bison open with 2 wins against top 10 teams. Could play big down the road. But, of course, the Valley is in between. Yeah. And a trip to Iowa.
Well, when you look at Iowa, a week off, Illinois State here, and then you go to Missouri State, but then South Dakota State here, then you got to go to Western Illinois, Northern Iowa, back-to-back weeks.
And
there's nothing
games.
Easy about that. Yeah, tough travel and tough trips and night games on top of that to boot. For North Dakota State, they're going to get in the film room and look at some things in the secondary and say, okay, what do we need to change up? What do we need to get better at before Iowa next week? What is your overall synopsis of the Bison, especially on the defensive side?
Well, defense just had to play so many snaps, but I think the defensive backfield today looked about a step and a half slow. Granted, you had to make the plays against them, but there were safeties that just were not quite there on some of those deep balls. Don't know if that's true. That's just my first reaction. I thought that they were just not quite there.
Well, regardless, North Dakota State, back-to-back games here at the Fargo Dome. They win in overtime. And they're 2-0 to start the season with a road trip to Iowa coming up next weekend. Thanks so much for joining us here on the KVLY KFYR Bison Network for our entire NBC crew from all over the state. For Beth Houle, Lee Timmerman, I'm Brian Sean, saying so long from the Fargo Dome. North Dakota State is 2-0. They'll remain number one in the country, but nothing easy here in the first couple of weeks of FCS play. We'll see you in a few weeks when Illinois State comes back for homecoming. Enjoy the road trip to Iowa, everyone. See you then. Bye-bye. All around, let's get on with the show. Get your horns up. The five-time champions are here. Get your horns up. We're going for a six-pack this year. Toss that coin up in the air. Bring them boys up to the line. Hold your horns up high because it's Bison time.